season at Super League's Glamour Club draws to a close, Kirk Kleinendorf's cupboard is still bare. A win here in Sheffield will secure second place in the league and send out a warning signal as the playoffs approach. Watch out, the Storm are getting ready to strike. Well, the atmosphere here at the Sheffield Arena is electric, a near capacity crowd here to see the Steelers' last home game. It is, of course, the final weekend of the regular season. The title may have been won, but for both Sheffield and Manchester, this is an important game in terms of pride. Well, the Sheffield Steelers went out of the Express Cup on Thursday, losing to the Bracknell Bees. Of course, the Manchester Storm never made it as far as the semi-final stage. So both these teams will be looking to redeem their seasons in the playoffs, which are just around the corner. They, of course, start next weekend. Nick Rothwell's with me in the studio. Nick, the playoffs, a chance for these teams to start again. It's like a whole new season, isn't it?
That's right. For a couple of these teams that maybe didn't do in the league what they wanted to do, the playoffs is a chance to start again. And for me, I mean the playoffs, to win the playoff championships, that's the pinnacle of the year.
Now, Manchester have hit some form of late, a seven-game winning run they've just been on. It's, of course, too late, but a bit of bad news for them. Jim Rithnak, there's some problem with him, isn't there? He's left.
Yeah, he's been released from the club because of a bit of a contractual dispute. He wanted to sign a new contract for next year. Manchester Storm and Kirk Kleinendorf didn't think that this was the time to do it, and they felt that the best thing to do was to let Rithnak go.
Of course, they have got a very good netminder in Jim Shervin. Well, the Manchester Storm know that 2 points will be enough to secure them second spot on the Super League table, and mean they won't need air until the semi-final. Sheffield's best possible finish is fourth. Now, that's how it stands at the moment with the playoff format of two groups. Group A, positions 1, 4, 6 and 8. Group B is 2, 3, 5 and 7. Manchester and Cardiff will always be in Group B, but we just don't know yet whether they're going to finish second or third in the league table. Well, Nick, we know that Sheffield Steelers leave it late. Last season, of course, they won the playoffs. Have they left it too late this season?
Not at all, Gabby. I mean, this is one of the most offensively potent teams in the league, and if they get things sorted out on the blue line and in between the pipes, they can go all the way again.
Now, I know you've been having a little look at the replay 2000. You spotted some stuff for us. Both these teams can score against each other, but just how are they going to defend against each other?
Well, here we have an example in Manchester, Sheffield against Manchester up there. Now, Andre Mallow has a puck from Sheffield, for Sheffield, and there's no pressure coming from Manchester, so we know they're backing up. He gets the puck to Ken Priestley. Now, Priestley in the neutral zone, he's skating through, he's got a couple of options, but watch this, okay? This is Manchester. They're lining up across their blue line. This is called standing up on the blue line. So it really doesn't give Sheffield an awful lot of options. Ken Priestley tries to skate it in. He gets poke checked. You can see here, he gets poke checked, loses the puck. Now Manchester, they gain possession in the neutral zone, turn things right back, go three on three against Sheffield. And watch what Sheffield do. They stand up on the blue line. So Manchester, again, they don't have a lot to do.
Excellent.
They skate in. You can see, you know, the Sheffield guy standing up. They skate in. They get the long shot on Greco. It's a good defensive system. It's kind of pre-trap era, you know, kind of a more old-fashioned way to do it.
So presuming these teams do take that kind of role tonight and stand up on the blue line, how do the other team then counteract that?
Well, there's a couple of things they can do, but what you most likely do is this. Manchester pick up the puck here in their zone. You can see now what this guy's got on his mind, he's going to gain the red line, the center line, the dotted red line there. He's got to get across there and dump it into the zone so it's no icing. Now here you can see, if we stop it here, he's done what you call a strong side rim. Now the thing with this is Greco, he can pick up the puck as the goaltender for Sheffield. Now watch this, what happens is that Rob Wilson comes to pick it up. Now this eliminates some of the options of his. All he can do is send it right back around. Manchester, what they've done is they've pinched in on the blue line and they've got the shot on the goal. For them, the dump has worked. Now this is another kind of dump that you can use. So Manchester again pick up the puck in their zone. So what he's going to do is he's going to gain the red line again, so it's not icing, and he's going to dump it in. Now if you just hold it here, what he's done is he's done a cross ice dump. Now what this has done is this, Pierre Greco, he can't stop the puck here, he can't play it, so watch this. Woodcroft goes into to forecheck, he gets the puck, and the Manchester Storm eventually get it back to Viklander, who gets it across to Miller, and the shot on net. And then for them, the dump has worked again.
Thanks very much, Nick. Some things for us to look out for as the game progresses. Well, let's join our commentary team now as face-off is upon us. It's Bob Carroll, but first, hello, Tony Millard.
Well, just seconds to face off with our referee Mike Rowe centre-ice at the moment. During this first period, the visitors Manchester Storm defending the goal to our right in the darker strip. Sheffield, the home team, in front of a near packed house in the lighter strip, defend the goal to our left. And it's Manchester on the attack with Mike Morin going in. Mike Ware takes him out and shades him away from the boards as the puck is held up in the corner, deep in that Sheffield defensive zone. The chance for Morin to go for the wraparound. And what Jablonski it was who came desperately close there early on for the first goal.
Duffa Chase may be the order of the day. I'm certain that the Manchester Storm trying to put some pressure here on Sheffield defense early. Hibbert, very, very good in terms of cutting that short side down.
So the face-off to the left of the goaltender there tonight, who is Jim Hibbert in the nets for Sheffield. And still the puck is held straight into that corner. Sheffield now will get the break. This is Tony Hand spreading play right. Courtney knocks it down. The right winger, Big Ed Courtney, he's taken into the boards this time for Manchester by Kevin Hoffman. This is now Courtney battling to send it around the boards. Hand tries to dummy. Miller keeps it against the boards. Out comes the puck. Truck goes in from Ware. Just off target. Courtney tries to set it up, but now Manchester will get the break. This is Mike Morin. He's got Chris Miller getting forward. Good glove work there by Jim Hibbert in the Sheffield net tonight. We start by looking at the Sheffield squad. In total here tonight, a few men missing, but Jim Hibbert starting in goal. Ron Shute has got an elbow injury, but he is playing. Kent Priestley, who's got a cut in midweek and required stitches, he's there, number 9. An all-time British top scorer, Tony Hand, number 16. And that big goal scorer, Ed Courtney, in the lineup. There's Alex Dampier, their manager. Alongside him, just behind him, there, Clyde Toole, the coach. They work as a team. Face-off, though, again, in that Sheffield zone. A draw won by Manchester. Rubichuk with a snapshot, just off target. Priestley will knock it around the boards for Sheffield. Puck held up by Allison. He's got Longstaff now in front of him to his left. This is Kovacs. Flicking across goal. Woodcroft will come away for Manchester number 9. This is Craig Woodcroft. He's got support from Dale Jager, the defenseman getting forward. But Priestley it is. He clears the defensive zone for Sheffield. And Kovacs will get the break. Kovacs with a shot. The pad of the goaltender there, Grant Sherman knocks it away, and Sherman again having to be alert for that. This is Rubichuk for Manchester. Bit of pace early on here. Got support into the neutral zone though. Troy Neumeier is the defenseman for Manchester now getting forward. Rubichuk leads it for Katola. Katola with a shot just off target. Rick Brabant holds it up against the boards and flips it round. This is Ron Shuter for Sheffield. Sheffield being forced back here.
I think that's the key to the game for the Manchester Storm, Tony. They've got some very fast forwards. They're going to dump that puck in his zone, try and put a lot of pressure on the Sheffield Steelers defense, which is hurting at the moment, as we know, because they've got a few players out there, some guys playing a little bit out of position, so they'll try and add some pressure in that direction.
Sheffield now pressing this time. Sheffield, remember, in the lighter strip. This is Mike Ware getting forward, misses the puck over his stick there, and it's held up against the boards. The battle joined by Stephen Cooper. Comes to Nicky Chin. This is Ware. Looking for the man in front of the net, which is Chin. Chin can't get a stick on the end of that, and again, into the boards and knocked around the boards. This is Flinton for Manchester, number 22. All around the boards to Rick Brabant, can't collect that. But Ron Shuter is the Sheffield defenceman in possession. Their alternate captain. That will be dumped into the corner. Kevin Hoffman, the break for Manchester, kept in well by Tony Hand. This is Chris Miller, the top goal scoring defenseman in the league. Puck comes loose, run up the ice, produce an icing call, and that gives us a chance to check on the Manchester Storm squad. Tonight, as you've already heard, without the regular goalkeeper Jim Rivnak, who's returned to Canada, Grant Sherman is in goal. The newcomer Johnny Lorenzo, more on him in a moment. Big scoring defenseman Mikhail Wiklander and Chris Miller. Craig Woodcroft, one of the centermen, Dave Morrison, the captain, and the fast-skating Stefan Katola is number 42.
Kurt Kleinendorst, he's trying to get this team motivated. They're on a very, very strong winning streak at the moment, and they want to set that stage and keep it moving for the playoffs.
Puck held up against the board. Scott Allison is battling here. Chance for the break here, Jablonski. This is Tony Hand getting back, back-checking well, and Courtney will chase it in, but the icing call. Our referee tonight is Mike Rowe from the Northeast, and his two linesmen in support tonight. Paul Bronch and Michael Evans. Michael Evans is the one that's going to take the face off. Paul Bronch will take the blue line for this. Face off then for that icing call. It's deep in that Sheffield zone. Third face off there so far. Slap shot goes in for Miller. Good grub work by Jim Hibbert. A word about Jim Hibbert in the goal for Sheffield Steelers.
Well, we haven't seen him a lot this year, Tony.
Yes, the 23-year-old from Etobicoke in Ontario. Bob.
Here's the face-off once again, becoming very prominent, but nothing in front of Jim Hibbert, so he sees this puck the whole way. Well, we know now that he's got a very, very hot glove hand, and I'm sure that he'll be using that tonight, because there's a lot of offensive pressure here by the Manchester Storm.
This is O'Sheffield on the block. Scott Addison with the shot, just off target and lap power. This is Ed Courtney, 27, on this side. Puck comes out, knocked around the boards again. Tony Hando, he gains possession despite being pushed to the floor. Shot goes in from Rob Wilson. Knocked away, rebound comes to Addison, great chance for Sheffield. Didn't hit the target in the end, Scott Addison on that rebound. Could have made more of that. Still it's Sheffield pushing. Well, the Manchester goalkeeper Grant Sherman has to kill that stone dead. Little bit of rust up ground behind the net there. They all part it.
Well, Scott Addison, in my opinion, Tony, is very good offensively. We're going to have a look at that here, but it's the rebound that always gets a goalkeeper normally into trouble. Here he has to make that save on Addison. Of course, Addison kind of gets himself a little out of position for that shot. Maybe took his better shot away from himself. Nonetheless, Sherman has to come up with a good save.
Grant Sherman there in the next for Manchester Storm tonight, with Jim Hrivnak having departed. Grant Sherman from Brandon, Manitoba, a 27-year-old goaltender tonight for Manchester. This is Troy Neumeier. And a penalty call here. Manchester will get a power play. As soon as they lose possession, we've got a penalty call from referee Mike Rowe. He will delay that until they lose possession, which means they could take their goalie off and play with six out skaters until the penalty's called or until they score. Now we get the penalty call from referee Mike Rowe, and this will give us a power play to the Manchester Storm.
Well, there's Craig Woodcroft, the prolific goal scorer for the Manchester Storm, doing very well this year in all competitions, and they're real relying on him very, very heavily to try and create some offense going into the playoffs. We got Frankie Kovacs. I think he's gone to the penalty box, has he? Picking up a roughing call, I believe. It's a difficult one with these bigger players. Frank Kovacs, he's a big, strong guy. We saw that a lot last year, especially in his forechecking capabilities. And when he plays physical, you know, it's a question mark sometimes whether the penalty should be called or not.
Well, that power play statistic now, the White Manchester, Michael Viklander, Mikhail Viklander with the shot. And he's been prolific on the power plays with four power play league goals so far this season for Manchester Storm. They are second best in power play success to Sheffield. This is Craig Woodcroft. Katola sets up Viklander. Viklander tries to make the opening here for Gordon, for Dale Jago. Chance here, shot. Katola with a shot, charged down there by the courage of Corey Beaulieu. Dumped into the corner by Manchester, by Sheffield. Manchester will start here now with Katola, number 42. Fast skating Swede. Katola now will create space. He's got support on the blue line. Viklander can't get the shot away, but does win the puck back, despite the close attention there from Dion Del Monte. Katola again. Around the boards, Woodcroft, chance for Viklander. He gets the shot away. The rebound eventually cleared right up the ice there. And although Jim Hibbert didn't hold it, he defended well.
Well, the box is always used on a penalty kill, as we've discussed many times before, Tony. But look at this Manchester Storm. Once they gain the zone with that puck, look at them moving around. They're not allowing the Sheffield Steelers defense to settle whatsoever.
And look at that skating of Rick Brabant, the length of the ice there. Rick Brabant almost creating a chance, but still the battle is joined. This is Hilton Ruggles in possession. Shot goes in from Miller, deflection away. that Glander will knock it around. Puck held up behind the net.
That shot originating from the point there, Tony, going on the back of the net, which makes the faceoff come outside into neutral ice territory. Here's a good chance to maybe have a look at the way that the Manchester Storm are moving that puck in the offensive zone. Always drive that puck for the net. This time it's not working. No one there for any sort of a rebound, but there you see the puck lying on the back of the net. And of course, that reverts to where the faceoff actually goes, which just is outside the Sheffield blue line.
Well, the power play is coming to an end. Sheffield surviving this well at the moment. Waiting for Frank Kovacs to come back on the ice, but Sheffield get the break here now. Good work defensively for Manchester Storm from Kevin Hoffman. Hoffman will set his own team moving here. It's Mike Morin with a backhanded flip. Chris Miller. Miller sends Jablonski away. This is Miller. Can't get the shot in. Blocked by Ron Shudra. This is Frank Kovacs on the break, having come out of the penalty box. Tony Hand collects the loose puck. Chance here for Kovacs. Great save there by Grant Sherman. Morin will get the break. Got support from Dave Morrison. This is Jablonski now with the puck. Good defensive work. Back checking there from Scott Addison. Allows Sheffield a break now. Is Kovacs skips by one. Good defensive work and a poke check there from Dale Jago on the edge of his defensive zone. This is Allison now. Rob Wilson is the Sheffield captain. Starting to move like a well-oiled machine, this Sheffield side now. Allison taking it to the boards. Tough check there by Troy Neumeier. Still it's up against the boards. Neumeier will squeeze it out of that defensive zone. Only as far. Here is Wilson, the Sheffield captain. Jago makes a hit. Eventually, Longstaff takes a hit, but Vic Lander blocks the way. This is Neumeier, with space for Dale Jago here. Jago will get forward. The chase is on, and we're going to get the icing call here. The action will resume to the Manchester defensive zone. Well, they're enjoying it, a near-packed house here in the Sheffield Arena.
Well, you've got two of the top teams in the league, Tony, and they've got two of the bigger buildings in the league as well, so plenty of tremendous support.
They made the trip across the Pennines from Manchester. A bit of time off from work, some of them, I dare say.
Yeah, a lot of people get Saturday off. Not like you and me, eh?
Face off, baby, the Manchester side. Still no goals here. Sheffield Steelers nil, Manchester Storm nil. It's the one penalty, Frank Kovacs, a two-minute penalty for roughing. Another icing call will bring us another face-off. Well, ringside, Nick Rothwell has with him one of the injured players.
Yeah, I'm down here with Jeff Collinson and the Manchester Storm, Tony. Jeff, how's the finger going?
Well, it's getting better. It's taken some time, but it's slowly getting better.
Crucial time of the season. I know the title chase is out of the way, but you got to get ready for playoffs, eh?
Yeah, that's true. We, you know, it looks like we might have second place sewed up tonight with if we can get 1 point in our last two games. And now we're going to be preparing for the playoffs.
And a win tonight would send you into the playoffs on good stead, wouldn't it?
Yeah, we've got a lot of momentum right now. We're playing well, and I think we're peaking at the right time.
Thanks a lot, Jeff.
All right, thanks, Nick.
Well, they have momentum, but at the moment they're being forced to defend, and Longstaff has the opportunity. Good block there. And that big, tough defenseman, Troy Neumeier. But the break is on now. If Sheffield can come forward with Rob Wilson, their captain. There's David Longstaff, who's been suffering from a bit of flu, but still gets it into the corner. This is Ken Priestley setting up the chance, but nobody on the blue line to take advantage. Priestley, Bob, no ill effects, it seems, from that stitch cut of midweek.
Well, I'm sure he faced that sort of injury before, Tony, but like you said, they've also got him now up playing forward center ice again here tonight. He's a great skater. That's why the coaching staff are not scared to use him in alternative positions, but he's certainly more comfortable as a forward.
So good on the puck. But this is Mike Ware, one of the biggest players in the league. Now it's flipped in. Nicky Chin will chase this for Sheffield. Chin's big and tough when he gets into the corner. But here is Hilton Ruggles, the 34 for Manchester. Del Monte, interception here. This is Hilton Ruggles. Flinton getting forward. Set up here on for Stephen Cooper, and getting back well is Nicky Chin. cover here. No penalty call yet, but Ruggles. Well, we've got a little incident here which was spotted by the officials. And I think it's a tight offside call there.
Well, here's the incident that gets the fans aroused there. Is there a tripping call there? Eric Flinton certainly coming back, picking his man up. But Mike Rowe feels, no sir, he's with him every step of the way, and they're both battling for the puck. So on this occasion, no minor penalty called.
Face-off is just outside that Manchester defensive zone as a result of that offside call. Dave Morrison will try and win the face-off for Manchester, and does. Getting back well is number 77 there for Manchester Storm, Chris Miller. Top goal-scoring defenseman in the Super League this season. This is Miller. He clears it into the neutral zone. Good stick-handling qualities of Dave Morrison. Got support here for Mike Morin for Manchester. Round behind the goal he goes. Still Morin retains possession. Morrison picks up the loose puck for captain. This is Jablonski in support. Good stick work as Tudor takes him into the boards. This is Nicky Chin with a break for Sheffield. Slap shot dumped into the corner. Chance here for Chin on the backhand, and watched well and covered well by the goalkeeper Grant Sherwin. Sherwin had to be alert there.
One of the great things about the Manchester Storm is this puck comes down from the other end, but they're not outnumbered in their own zone. They've always got a guy high to make sure that they've got at least one back checker coming back.
The face-off then is deep in that Manchester Storm zone, and they're still under some pressure as Sheffield have started to get things moving, Bob, but at the moment passes are going to stick.
They are, you know, they're playing well tonight. I think they've got a point to prove, and I think they're a bit disappointed from not reaching that Express Cup final just on Thursday night. They're getting beat out by the Bracknell Bees, so they've got something to prove themselves, you know. Everybody's jockeying for position here in terms of the playoffs.
Season far from over in many ways. Lots of excitement to come. This is Craig Woodcock on Manchester. Much of it on Sky, but now the chance for Katola. Great bit of stick handling. Great goal! Stefan Katola! His 15th league goal of the season. Powerful skating. Manchester Storm take the lead, and their fans celebrate.
This play is very much created because the Manchester Storm always hit the high guy. In this particular case, Stefan Katola. Great goal scorer. Why? Because he takes his time and shows some confidence once he gets the puck around the net. Now have a look at this. He knows he's running out of room here. He goes to his backhand. He beats Hibbert. Hibbert going into the back of the net. He's backing up on this play like he should, because the guy's thinking deep potentially. Unfortunately, just slips underneath him.
Manchester will be delighted with that. They lead Sheffield by a goal to nil. But their record here is not great, because in six visits they've only won once. Well, the Manchester goaltending story is an interesting one this evening, because they have a spare goaltender down there who's Johnny Lorenzo, and he can't be used unless Grant Sherwin is either injured or sick. Johnny Lorenzo flew in only yesterday from Michigan. He comes from Quebec City originally. He's a 27-year-old with a Spanish passport. The only man he can replace is this man, Grant Sherwin, and that's only if he's injured or ill.
Well, Manchester Storm's return to form has definitely got a lot to do with Grant Sherwin. He's played very, very well lately. Certainly was involved in that big victory when Manchester beat the Air Scottish Eagles up in air, which isn't an easy thing to do.
But Sheffield now will have to pull this back here. This is Jablonski, wins the puck, and now the break is on here for Dave Morrison. Morrison switches right to Morin. Sheffield again pushed back, but now this is Ed Courtney, flicks it. Good combination play there. It's dumped into the corner by Scott Allison. Tony Hamm will chase it. Hoffman breaks up play here, and now it seems to me Chris Miller goes from end to end and keeps battling. Jablonski held off, but still retains the puck. No penalty call. Now Sheffield get the break. Manchester almost put on the hop, changing team members. Tony Hand, stick holding, handling qualities there, finds Longstaff. Longstaff, brilliant save there by Grant Sherwin. He guessed right and had to.
I'll tell you what, a heads up and tremendous play by Tony Hand to see the whole ice, the whole play in that situation. He caught the last guy, David Longstaff, the trailer, Nobody from the Manchester Storm defensively saw the guy even coming into the zone.
Kellen, the veteran, breaks up that one, but now Manchester get a chance to come forward again. But this is big Mike Ware, who will go all the way here. Ware will try the shot and does just off target. And this time, when he gets the second one back, that was alert indeed. He needed to beat Grant Sherman on that one.
Well, big Mike Ware, he's big and strong, 6'6" in stature. But I'll tell you, here's a little bit of puck handling skills for you for a big man. Look at that, gets his own rebound as well. Of course, a bit of a bad angle there, but he's trying to get things going for these Steelers.
Well, Mike Ware, one of the biggest players in the league, and that man there now, the informed goaltender, Grant Sherman for Manchester.
Well, Mike Ware coming over from the Cardiff Devils in the offseason, and, you know, in my opinion, he's one of the very much underrated players in this league. He can play very strong defensively, but as you see, Tony, you give him the opportunity to take that puck and move forward, he can do some damage offensively as well.
Different technique there, knocking it straight in. Chance here for Longstaff. Great opportunity here, and again, Sherman alert. And somehow Manchester kept that out with bodies backing, getting back in support for Grant Sherman. But now, once again, Ware knocks it left. This is Longstaff. Woodcock trying to set his team going. Dale Jago, attacking defenseman getting forward. This is Brad Rubichuk. Rubichuk knocks it into the corner under pressure from Ware. Ron Shuter tries to switch play. This is Kovacs now on the break for Sheffield. Gets a chance at the edge of the net there, and well, it was close for Ken Priestley, as he said. Manchester trying to get forward again. Shuter breaks up the attack. Intercepted by Eric Linton for Manchester. Ruggles will get through the middle. Ruggles can't get the shot away. Great interception there from Ron Shuter. But still, as the game opens out now and speeds up, that will go the length of the ice. Produces the icing call and the face-off at the Sheffield end.
Stephen Cooper, arguably the best British defenseman or British growing defenseman to play in the modern era of the game. He's done a great job. He had a bit of an injured season last year, but he's come on strong this year, and I think that he's really developed by the coaching of Kurt Kleinendorf. He moves the puck very, very well now. He's always been an exceptional skater.
Chance here again. Cooper wraps that goalwards, but good block there for Sheffield, albeit at some pain. And Dion Del Monte, who took that on the ankle, limps off. Tony Hand tries to clear the zone. Held up. Yeah, this is Cooper in possession. Stephen Cooper's shot it was that charged down by Dion Del Monte. He'll take the wrap, it seemed, on the ankle. This is Rob Wilson getting back. Now it gives Manchester a chance to change on the fly. But Sheffield gained possession in the neutral zone and now spread play. Knocked into the corner. This is Hoffman. Kevin Hoffman on the break. This is Dave Morrison, the Manchester captain. Jablonski knocks it down with his skate. Scott Allison for Sheffield. Too many clear shots on goal, but a chance here for Tony Hand, just runs out of space. Dave Morrison, centre-man and captain for Manchester in the starting lineup. He spreads it to Chris Miller, number 77. Morin in possession. Chance here on the edge of the crease. Brilliant save there. In the end, from Jablonski.
Just when you think nothing's happening, oh, all of a sudden pops a two-on-one. Morin. And that's Jablonski, I think. Look at the move. He makes the move across the ice. Superb goaltending by Jimmy Hibbert there. As he keeps those pads on the ice, Tony, slides along. So if Jablonski's going to have to score in that scenario, he's going to have to go up above those pads.
Well, both goaltenders having to be alert tonight because it's going from end to end very, very quickly.
I think the speed of this game is absolutely tremendous. Now, you've got two good skating sides, most undoubtedly, but the thing about it is they move the puck very well, and nothing can skate faster on that ice than that puck once it's going.
Draw one by Sheffield. This is David Longstaff. Behind his own net, they're battling to decide who takes possession. Ron Shuter takes over. Spreads play right as they clear that defensive zone. Priestley keeps going. Priestley spreads play left this time, switching well. Kovacs taken into the boards by Miller. Shooter goes for the shot, kicked away by Shervin. The rebound there, blocked this time by Chris Miller, and we've got a penalty call here, which will take yet another Sheffield player, I think, to the box this time.
It looks like Davey Morrison going to the penalty box here. He's going to pick up a hooking call. Davey Morrison, the captain of the Manchester Storm this season, coming over from Castle in the DEL last year. Former draft pick of the Los Angeles Kings. And what a tremendous signing that guy's been.
So the first power play of the game coming the way of the Sheffield Steelers, who have the best power play record in the Super League this season. Sheffield's power play record, they've scored 22 power play goals in 95 attempts when their opponents have been shorthanded. They will build from the back with Ron Shuver. Drake is on this side. Good skating by Priestley. Priestley will go for the shot, just off target. The power of his shot takes the rebound all the way back into the neutral zone. Priestley will have to come out. The Brabant with the interception. This is Neumeier knocking into the neutral zone and up the ice. No ice and call, of course, because Manchester are shorthanded. They've already played out the first half minute. And penalty killing. Manchester Storm third best in the league for that skill. Nicky Chin, big Welshman. Interception now, we've got a break on here, and we could have a shorthanded goal for Rick Brabant. Great save from Jim Hibbert with his left pad.
There's a perfect example, Tony, when they stack the blue line, I'm afraid you've got no alternative, you've got to dump the puck, because all your players are thinking offense at that time, so the puck doesn't go in. This is what happens. The puck goes loose, and it's a breakaway the other way, one-on-one against the goalkeeper. Hibbert, once again, having to be very sharp.
Still Sheffield nil, Manchester Storm one. And the goal for Manchester Storm coming from Stefan Pitola. Well, there's Rick Brabant in the box. He's 34 today, Rick Brabant. It's his birthday.
What a career he's had, eh, Tony, over his years in the British game, and a prolific, prolific goal scorer.
I think he might just want to celebrate with a goal. More on that in a moment. This is Rob Wilson for Sheffield. Tony Hand feels it stone dead, and Hand will fashion a move from the back. Allison switches play left. Courtney will chase it in. Held up against the boards. Battling there. Two for Sheffield against Miller. Hard-working defenseman for Manchester, number 77. But Priestley is back here on this side. Wilson back on the point. Courtney can't control the puck when it counts. Even Priestley can't keep it in. And with 15 seconds remaining on the power play, again, they'll have to move to take advantage. Allison leaves it for the trailer. This is Tony Hand. Hand with the shot. And once again, Grant Shervin with the save as Manchester get back up to strength. Successful penalty kill by the Manchester Storm.
The job is done here. An offensive opportunity is created because Scott Allison gains the blue line. Tony Ann sees he has no too many options here. He lets that shot go because he's also got players driving for the net. If there's a rebound, there's a good percentage chance that a Sheffield Steeler is going to get a crack at that puck.
Well, Grant Shervin having plenty of work tonight. A drink for Tony Hand. Just over 3 minutes of the period remaining, a period that's moved at a quick pace, but just produced one goal so far. And there's the impressive result of Manchester's recent penalty-killing exploits. The one power play goal in the last 33 attempts, including that one tonight. Still, Sheffield trying to fashion attack against the plexiglass. This is Nicky Chin for Sheffield. Serves the dummy well. Stephen Cooper almost buys it. And now Cooper will get the break here. We've got a two-on-one for Manchester Storm. Cooper has Ruggles on the far side. Looks for Ruggles. Ruggles' shot is denied by great defensive work there from Wilson with a cover. This is Brabant on the backhand. Flinton chases it in. Flinton goes for the wraparound. Well,
Corey Bolio's got the bear hug there on Eric Clinton. But you can see what happens. That all results because they have a little extra pop there at the goalkeeper of the Sheffield Steelers. And those defensemen certainly come in there quick to the rescue.
Well, no doubt the officials will sort that out.
Here's the two-on-one by the Manchester Storm. A little bit too late, right at the time there. Stephen Cooper running out of room, perhaps. He's going to make that pass. It has to happen earlier. But they do get a crack at it again. Unfortunately, on this circumstance, too many Sheffield Steelers back, plugging up those lanes.
Well, three of them there within about 4 foot of their goaltender. They certainly weren't going to allow any space there at all. Jim Hibbert.
This young guy, he's come off the bench, Tony, and I think he's done very, very well, hasn't he? He's a university player. St. Francis Hughes coming out of Canada. But he's concentrating very well here. Number one, Piero Greco, taking a bit of a rest tonight.
Well, he's had some league work this season. That goal he conceded tonight was the 21st against him in league action this season, but clearly showing promise. And this time of the season, with the playoffs coming up, two strong goaltenders, Nick Rothwell said last year, they need that, and they've got it. This is Sheffield. Good work here by Ron Shuter. Shuter goes for the shot. Cleared again into the neutral zone, but Woodcroft can get something going here for Manchester as he dumps it into the far side. Tries to read the boards. Priestley will chase, and that'll produce an icing call, and the face-off again will be in that Sheffield defensive zone. Singing and dancing here, and those are the Manchester fans. They have similar music in their own arena, and it doesn't matter what age, and those girls do it every week. Steeler Dan. Saw him on his little motor scooter earlier on.
He takes his game seriously, doesn't he, Tony? He's right behind us, as a matter of fact, so we better not say anything about him.
Is Stefan Katola in possession, goal scorer. Katola loses out. Tony Hand, David Longstaff shows good skill there. Break is on, shot from Priestley, powerful. And the goaltender Sherbin is equal to that. Well, we saw a vicious shot not produce a goal from Ken Priestley in midweek. Here again, we can see the power of the former NHL man. Here again, face on. We see it as Grant Sherbin does here. But he was equal to it and got the angle tight. Priestley didn't have much space to shoot at. There's Grant Sherbin's record. He's conceded 31 goals this season. A 92% record, and that's a good save record. That includes tonight's efforts too. Improving it. Shot goes in again. Smothers the rebound with his pads and... certainly a little bit of rough stuff over this side as Dale Jago and Frank Kovacs have words with each other. Well, the officials trying to keep things moving. There's the shot. The save at the second attempt here. Grant Sherbin, number 35, in the nets tonight for Manchester Storm. At the moment, providing he stays fit and well, Mr. Sherbin will see out the season. But that man, Frank Kovacs, penalty earlier on tonight, but, strong big player. Face off then, deep in the Manchester zone now. Manchester would love to pull a goal back before the break. Just under a minute and a half remaining in this period. Loose puck in front of goal. Oh, a great chance there for Kovacs, bumping puck and didn't connect. The puck is cleared up the ice, and that'll produce again a face off in the Manchester defensive zone for that icing call. A great chance for Frank Kovacs. Sheffield fans may think he could have scored. Grant Sherbin, the man that kept it out. Previous three Super League games he started, each of them have been won by Manchester, and his save record there is better than 19 out of 20. 70, 71 seconds remaining on this first period. The action is deep in the Manchester defensive zone. Remember, it's Manchester Storm in the darker strip defending the goal. Right, they lead by a goal to nil. Stefan Katola the scorer. Priestley though knocks it goalwards, almost takes a deflection there, and somehow Sherbin comes up with that. It took a deflection at point blank range, and the goaltender was sharp to keep that out from Scott Allison's stick. We can see the shot here from Priestley, and taking a deflection there either off a skate or off Allison's stick, and Sherbin coming up with the glove hand hot again. He was hot there. Still the action, putting Manchester under pressure, but they'll be happy with this one goal lead. A minute left in the period. Manchester break now. 77 is Chris Miller sending Morin away. Mike Morin will dump it into the corner. Goaltender Jim Hibbert knocks it around the boards. It comes out here. Miller goes for the shot, narrow angle. Sheffield pushing forward. They'll try and get it out to the blue line. They still fail to clear the zone, and Hibbert, well, he has to be equal to that. Priestley knocks it around the boards. Hand kills it stone dead. Allison will clear the defensive zone. A good support here now from Priestley. This is Priestley getting forward. Goes for the shot. Another save from Sherbin. Rebounds down from the plexiglass into the final 20 seconds of the period. If Schuder can keep this in, Schuder goes for the shot. Courtney switches it goalward. Sherbin watches it carefully. Mike Morin will knock it around the boards. Killed down by Scott Allison. Got back by Tony Hand. Hand looks for support, gets it, another save. Flicked away with the stick hand, just as the whistle goes, to end a lively period. A period played in plenty of pace and with little in the way of penalty calls. Each side survived a power play, but the only goal of the period came from the fast-skating Swede, Stefan Katola, put Manchester in front. At the end of the first period, Sheffield Steelers 0, Manchester Storm 1.
Couple of big games coming up tomorrow on Sky Sports 2. At 12 noon, it's Football League and the match between Birmingham City and Sheffield United. That's followed at 3 o'clock on Sky Sports 1 by the Premiership clash between Newcastle United and Leeds United. Live football coming up tomorrow on Sky Sports. Right now, though, it's live ice hockey. We're in the final weekend of the Super League, and here we are at the Sheffield Arena. They're taking on the Manchester Storm. Just one goal there in the first period. Shots on goal fairly even. The Sheffield Steelers outshooting, though, the Manchester Storm at the moment, 18-13. Well, Bob Carroll's with me at the moment. Bob, would you say it was fairly even that period, but Manchester just seemed to have the better opportunities there?
I think it was a fairly even period, Gabby. And speaking to you before, I feel that, you know, maybe Manchester had a few better quality scoring opportunities, but not much in it.
Got into it early on, Manchester. Stefan Katola getting on the end of the one and only goal of the first period.
Well, one of the things that I like about the Manchester Storm is they move the puck up well to the guy ahead of the play, if you like. In other words, if you're ahead of him and he can get that puck, you've got to give it to him. And this is what creates a scoring opportunity. Katola is an exceptional skater, and he splits the defense here, and they just basically can't catch him either.
Great solo effort, wasn't it?
Oh, it is. But he also takes time and a lot of confidence here in making sure that he gets a good shot away.
Holds himself up there well as well. It looked like he was going to go down face first, didn't he, on the ice?
Well, he's got some pressure on him, but he also goes to the backhand. That's not easy either.
No, Rick Brabrandt having a good game as well, as ever. Almost got himself on the score sheet. A good chance for him would have been another solo effort as well, wouldn't it?
It was. Now, Nick spoke about this at the start of the game, where if you're going to dump the puck in, that's great, because there's all these Manchester Storm standing Sheffield Steelers up coming out of the zone, and this is what happens if you don't do that. Rick Brabrandt goes the other way.
Of course, Hibbert got there for that one. Hibbert playing today. We saw on Thursday Greco in nets. He didn't have the best game. Would you say that this is Alex Dampier making a tactical move rather than just resting Greco?
Well, I think it's a combination approach, Gabby, and speaking to Alex Dampier, I think he wants two hot goaltenders for the playoffs, which is always a concern that most teams have, but Hibbert's sort of, you know, been out of the limelight, and he's coming in and he's trying to prove himself as well. So, you know, I think there's a combination approach here.
We've talked about netminders all season, of course, the importance of them, and it's clear again today. It's emerged that Jim Rivnak's left the Manchester Storm. They've got a new netminder down there on the bench who, of course, can't play. Sherbin having another good game as well.
He is. The last few games that the Manchester Storm have played, Gabby, Grant Shervin has been in the nets, and he's played exceptionally well. One of the things that they're all talking about there is when you need that big save, that's when that goaltender has to come up hot. And that's one of the things that Shervin's doing now. And I'm not so certain that Jim Hrivnak did that all season long.
Thanks very much for the moment, Rob. Well, a big night coming up on Thursday. It's the Express Cup final in Newcastle. The Express, of course, the newest competition to enter the ice hockey season. It's a chance for the teams to lift another piece of silverware before the playoffs start the weekend after. Well, the finalists were decided on Thursday, so let's let Nick Rothwell talk us through how they got there.
Nottingham traveled to the Centre Marina on Thursday night, and despite scoring first through Jamie Leach, it was going to be a battle for the Panthers as they were riddled with injuries and air were flying high after securing the league title. And the Panthers fell 3-2 down after the first period, the Eagles' third and part of a hat-trick for Sean Byram. The second period saw the Eagles soar, four goals more with no reply from Nottingham. Viet scored two, and this one just squeezing by O'Connor. Sam Grolo put the Scottish team 5 goals ahead with this one. In the third period, despite 2 goals from the Panthers, Ayr sailed into the final, taking their tally to 12. Wolf sending in the heat, and Viet taking advantage of Panthers standing goalie Pete Russell, who took over from O'Connor with 13 minutes left on the clock. Bracknell visited Sheffield with a 2-goal cushion after the first leg, but Sheffield were determined to claw back. But Bracknell wouldn't budge. They were on the score sheet first with Brian Pellerin, who found the back of the net. The Steelers leveled it up in the first period with Kim Cranston getting the edge. The second period was a hard-fought battle by the two teams with referee Nigel Boniface handing out 22 minutes in penalties. In the third, Sheffield went one up on the night, and one behind on aggregate with only 91 seconds left. The Steelers swarming the Bees' net, and captain Rob Wilson hitting the twine. Pressure then mounted for the Bees when the Steelers pulled Greco, but that left the door wide open for Chris Brandt to secure the win on aggregate. So Ayr looking for their third trophy this season, and Bracknell in their first ever major final.
Well, it's a one-off game. Anything can happen, so do join us on Sky Sports 3 at 8 o'clock. It's live and exclusive. Delighted to see the Bracknell Bees making their first ever final, and will Ayr be lifting their third silverware of the season? Well, stay tuned, because we're going to be announcing the winners of our cup final competition. We gave you the chance on Thursday, of course, to win a VIP package to that one. Bob Carroll, brilliant to see Bracknell there. It's something we didn't expect. If any of us had had to put money on it, we wouldn't have said Bracknell would have made a final this season, would we?
I agree with that. You know, they're very much an up-and-coming team, though, and they're a bunch of guys that really muck together and play well, and I think they're exceptionally coached. They've got a great coach there.
And, of course, the Scottish Eagles. Who would bet on them not taking the treble or even the quadruple this season?
I mean, I follow you there. I mean, they've been so consistent all season long, and I think that's one of the great things about the Ayr Scottish Eagles. But they're going to be a difficult team to beat, and once they sniff victory or close to it.
Of course, Bracknell's got the psychological advantage of knowing they can beat them. They have beaten them. They did it on Sky this season, so it's going to be a fantastic evening, isn't it?
Well, neutralized territory, if you like. Both teams sort of visitors, but I think it'll be an exceptional final.
Well, I know we're all looking forward to that one. Right now, this evening, there are other ice hockey games going on up and down the country. Let's catch up with some of the results. As we know, here at the Sheffield Arena, Manchester leading them by 1-0. Basingstoke 1-0 up against Nottingham. Nottingham not having the greatest of weeks, of course, going out of the Express Cup, now down to Basingstoke, who are going to finish seventh this season. Bracknell 2-1 up against Cardiff. Cardiff's disappointing season continues there. Well, on Sunday, you can go and see some games for yourself. The Scottish Eagles, the champions, are at home against the Steelers. It's been a busy few days for the Steelers. The Devils against the bottom club, the Newcastle Cobras, at the Ice House. And the Manchester Storm taking on the Bracknell Bees at home at the 9X Arena. That's the last day of the Super League, of course, on Sunday. Well, the Manchester Storm fans got a lot to be happy about after that first period, because their team are 1-0 up, knowing that they can finish second for the season in the Super League. What's going to happen in the second period? Well, join us soon. Stefan Katola here, getting the one and only goal for the first period. Join us for second after the break. Live basketball coming up tomorrow night. The London Towers take on the Birmingham Bullets tomorrow night, 6:30 after the football on Sky Sports 1. Right now, though, it's live ice hockey. It's the last weekend of the Super League. The Sheffield Steelers at home to the Manchester Storm, live and exclusive on Sky Sports 2. Well, we're almost ready to start the second period, so let's join our commentary team. It's Bob Carroll, but first, Tony Millard.
A second period that could see the game swing or could see Manchester Storm go further in front. The only goal that's counted so far, Stefan Katola, the impressive and speedy 26-year-old Swede, putting them in front. The visitors, Manchester Storm, during this period, in the darker strip, will defend the goal to our left. Sheffield, the home team, looking for a win. In fact, they've lost 7 of their last 10 Super League games. They need a win to go into the playoffs, and they're defending the goal to our right. This is Dave Morrison, the captain. Good body check hitting him. Caught by Ron Schuder on the edge of the blue line there to send Dave Morrison flat. And again, Morrison picks it up well. This is Mike Morin. Morin's got Jablonski to his left, but Jablonski's gone in too early. He's offside, and that produced a face-off just outside that Sheffield defensive zone. So Stefan Katola's goal in the first period, the only one of the game so far. The visitors, Manchester Storm, in front. Remember, they've won just once here in Sheffield Arena. That was in the Benson Hedges Cup when they won 9-4 earlier this year. But for Sheffield, their recent record is not too impressive in the Super League. 3 of their last 10 league games. Manchester dump it into the corner. Kevin Hoffman on the end of the stick there. This is Ron Schuder for Sheffield, spinning it clear. Chance here on the break here for Ed Courtney. The pass is from inside his own defensive zone. A three-line pass, that one pretty near. And Ed Courtney will have to come back. So will everybody else, deep into the Sheffield defensive zone in front of goalkeeper Jim Hickman. There's the pass from Ron Schuder. One line, two line. He's inside the attacking zone and he picks it up.
Would have been kind of interesting there if Jeff Jablonski just would have touched that. Could have been a completely different story.
Sheffield with their number one line out there, Tony Hand, centering Scott Allison and Ed Courtney. But now it's Manchester coming forward. Hoffman knocks it around the boards. On this side, Allison will try and help it out. Schuder is forced back. Knocked around the boards by Mike Ware. Ed Courtney in possession now, tries to switch play. Good interception by Mike Morrison and an interchange of passing. Morrison with the shot. Courtney tries to clear the danger. Morin knocks it goalwards. And this time, Jim Hibbert knocks it down well, the goaltender. In short, all by one goal so far.
One of the great things about the Manchester Storm is even when they dump the puck for possession, if Sheffield win that battle, they still manage to keep the puck in the zone, which is a good quality. An excellent sign from that short-sighted defenseman there to keep the puck in the zone. Jimmy Hibbert, hey, what a job he's done since coming into the nets here tonight. Great save percent average there. But that's not always easy when you don't get a whole lot of ice time in game-type situations.
Sheffield Arena in front of 8,000 people, a little bit different than the practice rink, perhaps. This is Kovacs for Sheffield. Manchester put under some pressure, looks for the trailer, but it's Katola wins it back, and good cover now for Sheffield from David Longstaff, using his captain here, Rob Wilson. Wilson takes it round behind his own net. Craig Woodcroft with the forechecking from Manchester. Wilson still pushed back. Good interception there for Brad Rubichuk. This is Katola, the goal scorer. Knocks it in, will chase it here, got support from Rubichuk. Rubichuk and Katola go in together. Eventually puck one back here and knocked around the boards by Rob Wilson. Dale Jogo tries to find Katola. Priestley gets possession, flicks it on for Longstaff. He can't control the puck, and Sheffield captain Rob Wilson has to pick it up in the neutral zone. Flicked on by Priestley. Good cover by Jago. Shots few and far between so far in this period.
Some good tight defensive work happening here though, Tony. A lot of one-on-one pairing, defensive work, if you like, happening here. Players making sure they hang on to their guys.
This is Frank Kovacs. Manchester, the visitors, leading by a goal to nil. Looking for their first league victory in this arena.
How about that for a little size, Tony? They're growing big out where I come from. 6'2", 15 stone, 5. He's just down the road. Regina, Saskatchewan native.
I saw that. Saskatchewan boys unite.
I'm glad you're picking up on that now, anyways.
Many years ago, Bob, there was a little centerman at Wembley Lance called George Beach who came from that very town.
I think he was a top man in those days too, wasn't he?
They called him the Regina Peach.
There's Viklander. He's playing with a bit of an injury at the moment, but nonetheless, he's bearing on through, and they certainly rely on him for his offensive power and certainly his use on the power play.
Well, they're having to reset the clock because the puck fired up loose, hit the clock, knocked the mechanism, and they're now resetting to the time actually transpired during this period. And of course, it's timed accurately down on the timekeeper's bench, and we're back to the time left. And there's our referee, Mike Rowe, who will get us underway with that clock properly reset. Face off then, deep in the Manchester zone as Sheffield try to get back in this game. Manchester leading by a goal to nil. That much has remained on the clock. Shot goes in from Mike Ware, takes a deflection away off the left pad of the goaltender Grant Sherwin. Chasing back is Ron Schuder for Sheffield. Visitors Manchester, impressive forechecking tonight, but let's see what they can do here as Nicky Chin gets forward for Sheffield. Chin knocks it across the zone. A chance here on the backhand here for Del Monte. He retains possession. Good defensive technique here, and now the break could be on here. It goes Rick Brabant. Brabant checks back, looks for support, gets it from Ruggles going in front. This is Hilton Ruggles. Del Monte in possession. Shakes off the attentions of Eric Clinton. Brabant still worries him. Good stick work, good defensive work here, and now the break is on. Del Monte, knocked down well by Cranston. He switches it right now. And this is good skating from Big Mike Ware. Into the corner it goes, and now Manchester get the break here. Stephen Cooper. Del Monte again helping out at the back. But Corey Beaulieu can't control the puck and has to fire it back around the boards. Now Del Monte collects it again. Beaulieu behind his own net. Still the Manchester forecheck is on to deny them a chance to settle. Scott Allison has to come back into his own zone before going forward. Tony Hand in support. Allison going all the way. This is Ed Courtney with the shot just off target. Wilson knocks it around. Tony Hand behind the net. Chance here. Good save there. Good poke check by the goaltender. Grant Sherwin knocking that away, and that'll produce the icing call and take the action deep down to the Manchester zone. Well, Sheffield have some injured players. One of them is with Nick Rothwell.
Tommy, how's the injury going?
That's not bad. It's a tough time to pick up an injury, you know, this late in the season and heading into the playoffs, but hopefully it's just a little shake up to my body and I'll be all right.
And of course, last game here in Sheffield in front of almost a full house as well.
Yeah, you know, I think last year when Manchester set the precedent with the big record crowd at their place on the last game, I think the rivalry's picked up, and our fans have come to show what they got tonight, I think.
Thanks a lot, Tommy.
No problem, thank you.
Puck clear beyond the neutral zone by Manchester. Tommy Plummer still probably a part to play in this season. An interception there, Morin sprays it left. Jablonski can't keep it in. Wilson gets the break for Sheffield. Puck dumped into the corner. Courtney wins it back for Sheffield. Molio bundles forward, big hit. Hand gets the thick goal, which takes a deflection, and somehow Grant Sherwin knocks it down.
We get a turnover again in the offensive zone of the Sheffield Steelers. Tony Hand feels, hey, listen, there's going to be somebody in front of the net. We've got two players there. But Grant Sherwin does a great job because he lifts no rebound whatsoever.
Well, Tony Hand there, some record this player. Leading all-time goal scorer, leading all-time point scorer in British ice hockey, and leading point scorer this season in the Super League. In all games, he scored 77 points in 55 games. This is Woodcroft for Manchester. Dale Jago knocks it right. Neumeier knocks it into the corner this time. Woodcroft will chase it. Stefan Katola. Rubachuk knocks it out. Jago with the shot. Yes, deflection! Goaltender Hibbert didn't get to that. And Dale Jago ran home his 6th-league goal of the season with some power.
Well, that puck goes deep into the corner, but so does the compression of the defense of the Sheffield Steelers, because Dale Jago's got all kinds of time here, no one covering him as he steps in and lets that big slap shot go. But good heads-up play there, because that puck comes across the ice, deep in the offensive zone, and Jago makes no mistake with a huge slap shot. I like this because, man, you've got to watch your point men, especially in your zone. You can't leave a guy like him wide open like that.
Well, that's Dale Jago's 6th-league goal of the season. Jim Hibbert actually got a touch on it, Bob, as the replay show, but it was simply too fast for him.
Well, he's got that cracker of a slap shot. You wonder how he gets it away with that short blade on his stick, but nonetheless, it works for him.
Well, they call him Shotgun Dale Jago in the 9X Arena. He showed it there. Manchester lead 2-0. On Schuder chases it. Longstaff wins possession for Sheffield. As they try to clear the danger. Manchester mounting pressure. Patola spreads it wide. Chance at the shot. Goal was brilliant work by the goaltender there. Woodcroft almost getting a touch to put that in. But diving at his feet, Jim Hibbert produces the save.
We're almost looking at an identical play as the last goal was scored against. Here's Katola with a big pass up and across. Woodcroft just about gets a tip in there. Once again, that far side defenseman, big Troy Neumeier, has all kinds of time to get his shot away. He's got a heads up move as well, because he's not thinking slap shot. He's looking tip in.
Well, they've got some power on the blue line, because we've now got Jago and Neumeier out there, and certainly Vic Lander and Miller, they've scored goals aplenty this season. That's where Manchester have some power. A chance here on the break. This is Priestley. Priestley checks back, goes for the shot. This time it's off target. Kovacs follows in well. Neumeier tries to clear the danger. This is Longstaff. And this time Sherman holds it under his elbow and against his body. Grant Sherman doing a job for Manchester tonight.
Well, Kenny Priestley can create scoring opportunities out of little or nothing. And this is what the Sheffield Steelers, I think, do so very, very well.
Face off then deep in the Manchester defensive zone as a result of that save. Linesman down there saying, come on, join us, Paul Branch. We've got a problem here with the goaltender to our right. Jim Hibbert is having to redress himself. And play delayed for that.
Well, sometimes these netminders, a lot of the players actually, they hold their pants up, if you like, with a skate lace right around the middle of the waist. It gives you a bit of a belt effect. There you see it, and I think that's probably come loose. His goal pants falling down a little bit. You don't want to lose your pants in a game like this.
Well, it takes them a while to get dressed, and if they have a problem, well, play has to stop for that. Other players can go off the ice.
It's just not so easy for them either. They got all kinds of buckles everywhere, you know. Technically,
though, Bob, it's only the goaltender's allowed to adjust his dress on the ice, isn't it?
And even sometimes, I mean, you know, if a goaltender's doing that quite a bit, you know, the referee will call delay a game.
Well, game delayed for a while, no penalties. And Sheffield in possession. This is Nicky Chin. Good work by Chin to shake off the tensions of Rick Brabant. Still, Chin keeps going. He's got support here from Del Monte. Del Monte with the shot. Puck sails up over the bar, comes down off the plexiglass. It's Nicky Chin battling behind the goal. This is Chin and Del Monte combining. Chin goes for the slap shot. Sherman produces a save again with his chest and knocks the rebound stone dead.
One-on-one support all the way through this. Nicky Chin using his physical presence here. But every time that the Sheffield Steelers are looking to create scoring opportunities, I'm afraid there's a man on them very desperately. Grant Sherman here having to make a good save. Nicky Chin, whose angle maybe isn't the greatest from there, but Sherman again comes way out of his net to cut that angle down.
Well, Nicky Chin, his hair is now blonde under that helmet. Once described by a friend of mine as looking like a pint of Guinness.
Well, when you're Nicky Chin size, Tony, I mean, you can wear your hair whatever color you want it, but he's one of these guys, you know, that I feel under Alex Dampier and Clyde Toole, all right, has really flourished because he's a big, strong guy, and they're using that physical presence to his advantage and certainly the team's advantage. They get the puck deep in the zone, they fetch guys like him right after it, and of course, when you got a defenseman, knowing that you got a big forward like that running after you, I'll tell you, you move that puck quickly and sometimes in a bit of haste, which causes problems.
Now Monty trying to set up the chance behind the net, but good defensive qualities here as Dale Jago combines well with Hilton Ruggles to send it away. Good work here again. This is Rick Brabant. Brabant spreads play left. Neumeier with a shot. Ruggles misses the puck. Eventually Cranston gets it at the second attempt. And we've got a penalty call here from referee Mike Rowe. And I think we're going to see Corey Beaulieu going to the box.
I think he's going off on a cross-checking call.
That will give Manchester their second power play of the game. And I can tell you that Corey Beaulieu is not too happy with that. He now has 184 minutes in penalties this season, with those two added to it in all competitions, the big defenseman.
Well, Bert Beaulieu came to the Sheffield Steelers last year, and, you know, he's a good, strong physical presence back there. And, you know, when guys get the puck and they start moving it and that sort of thing, you know, they move it a little faster when they know he's in the territory.
Sheffield Steelers 0, Manchester Storm 2. There's Corey Beaulieu in the penalty box. And certainly Corey Beaulieu has spent some time in the box. The power play is with the Manchester Storm, who lead by 2-0. Manchester Storm, second in the league power play statistics this season. The success. But now we've got a chance here. This is Tony Hand chancing a short-handed goal for Sheffield. Good angle from the goaltender Grant Sherman. Yet another save.
Well, the Manchester Storm, when they're setting up and trying to go into the offensive zone, they look to hit the wide guy who's potentially open, but a good forecheck here by the Steelers creates a two-on-one. Now Chris Miller does a good job because he hangs on to Ed Courtney and allows Michael Wicklander just to concentrate on Tony Hand, which makes it a lot easier for that man there, the goalkeeper, Grant Sherman.
Sherman playing like a man inspired tonight, but still his goal under pressure. Mike Ware with the shot, Sherman with the save yet again. Now the break is on here. This is Mike Morin in possession. Morin shakes the tensions of his man off Ron Schubert, looks for support, still Morin in possession. This is Dave Morrison, the Sheffield captain. Good interception here by big Mike Ware. Ware will move away out of his defensive zone. Good defensive cover, but Ed Courtney comes in. Good cover on the edge of the crease there from Wicklander. Dave Morrison now has a 3-on-2 situation here. Morrison will shoot goal, goalwards. Ware cuts out the pass. Still Morrison battles. Jablonski. Jablonski still in possession, gets it back to Miller on the blue line, nearly gets the deflection on Morin's stick. Could have been goal number three. Wicklander battles for the puck. This is Mike Morin, taken into the boards by Mike Ware. Morrison gets possession. Interception by Ware will get the break now for Sheffield. He will knock it into the corner. The cover is on from Miller and Jablonski, chased in there by Frank Kovacs. This is Craig Woodcroft. Half a minute remaining on the power play now as Manchester get the breakaway with Woodcroft. This is the fast-skating Katola. Woodcroft has a trailer, but he's taken round behind the net by the veteran Chris Kellen. This is Wicklander. Wicklander's shot knocked away by the goaltender Jim Hibbert, saved that well.
Well, Wicklander having an opportunity. They try and key on him, as we know, to get that big slap shot of his away. But he's got his head up all the time, and that's a sign of a great defenseman. Because when he's shooting the puck, he knows where he's shooting it. And he saw Katola beside of the net there. He just wanted to hopefully get some sort of a tap in if possible.
Well, Sheffield improving that power play, that penalty killing statistic. Corey Beaulieu is now back on the ice. And during that power play situation, side with the advantage had simply one shot on goal, and Sheffield got two during that time on Grant Sherwin at the other end.
Very few penalty minutes in this game. Corey Bolio just coming out of the penalty box. But I know that Alex Dampier last year in signing Corey Bolio, he wanted to add some good physical presence to his defense, to his blue line corps. Hence, you get in a big, strong guy, Bolio, one of the heavy men in the league. 17 stone, and he knows how to play with it.
I think probably the heaviest ball, but that isn't he?
Well, he'd be in the contention, certainly. I mean, I like the size of Wicklander as well. I'm just looking, he's 16-1, but there's still a bit of a difference. That's 245 pounds or something like that. That's
Mike,
heavy.
Might wear 16 and a half, isn't he? This is Ruggles with the shot. Save at the second attempt by Jim Hibbert. Knocked away by Rob Wilson off the plexiglass.
Getting back to those defensemen, though, they get all those big guys back in there because they like to protect their goalkeeper, move guys out from in front of the net, and allow these fellas to see the puck the whole way.
Well, Jim Hibbert, been busy tonight. Playing his part.
Here's Hilton Ruggles with a couple of cracks at it. That puck just deflects, but Hibbert once again playing a good stand-up type position, letting it hit him on his shoulder, taking the play and making that big save.
Well, they'll have another go at the faceoff there. Now, goaltenders left deep in that Sheffield defensive zone, with Manchester leading by 2-0 and nearly halfway through the game. Eyes from Michael Evans will drop the puck this time. Rick Brabant will try and win that face-off. Del Monte it is that squeezes Brabant off the puck. This is Bolio getting forward. Bolio knocks it into the corner. Chin will chase it forward. Del Monte wins it back. Knocked out of that defensive zone this time by Mikhail Wicklander. Brabant looking for the break here, and I think he thought he was hooked down. He's going to get the penalty here. Bolio is going to go to the box for his second penalty of the game to put Manchester on the power play.
Well, Rick Brabant trying to break away. Tim Cranston, I think, put the hook in on him. Above all that, there's a crowd of players, but it's actually Tim Cranston's stick. There it is. You see him kind of slip in and out of there. He's pretty good at that. But Rick Brabant was thinking offense there. And of course, he gets hooked, and Tim Cranston sits 2 minutes on a hooking call.
Well, Red Bob, Cranston with the earlier hook, and still the power play with Manchester Storm.
Well, this is something the Steelers certainly got to get out of habit of doing. I mean, coming into the playoffs, they want to make sure that they're playing at full strength. I mean, you're going to give teams like the Manchester Storm opportunities with a man advantage. They're certainly and eventually going to capitalize.
Well, Tim Cranston, 35, is the second oldest player in the Sheffield lineup, second to Chris Callum. It's Manchester with Dale Jago now coming forward on the power play. Jago knocks it goalwards. Hibbert knocks it down and clears the puck up the ice. Knocked down here by Wicklander. Wicklander dumps it in. Bolio in possession. He can whack it up the ice. No icing call, of course, because Sheffield are the man short with Manchester on the power play. This is Stefan Katola, the fast-skating Swede. One goal already tonight. Katola knocks it back. Jago will get in on the blue line. Got support from Wicklander, who has a shot. And somehow, Hibbert got back just in time there, and the fisticuffs break out between Rob Wilson and Craig Woodcroft.
Well, Woody a bit unhappy there because, of course, he has to pay the price if he's going to take a crack at Hibbert and hope for a rebound. And that's what those big guys are out there for. Let's clear the net. Great cross-ice pass. Once again, the key player, Wicklander, because he's the guy with a big shot. But it all starts to happen. There's Woody looking for some sort of a rebound. Brad Rubicek's in there. Nothing to have. Good protection.
Well, a little bit change of personnel. Corley Bolio involved, but he's now left the ice and back on the ice. For Sheffield, four outskaters at the moment. Big Mike Ware's there.
You know, you have a look at that Sheffield Steelers defensive corps. They got Rob Wilson, they got Mike Ware, they've got Corey Bolio. Ron Shooter, he's not a small guy either. He's 6'2". You can see the size and presence that's trying to be created out there. Of course, when you do that, you know, you don't always have guys that are the quickest in the world, but nonetheless, these guys can also do good offensive skills as well.
Minute now remaining on the power play. Manchester in possession. This is Craig Woodcroft having recovered from that little boxing match. Good forechecking by Tony Hand. Hassling and harrying there, but now, well, Woodcroft couldn't gather that puck, and the goaltender Hibbert it is that knocks it around the boards. Allison knocks it down and clears the defensive zone. Hand looks for the pass. Good support here, gets forward. Mike Ware loses Hand as the trainer. Hand has a man on the far side. It's Shooter with the shot knocked away. This is Vic Lander. Vic Lander will come forward with 25 seconds remaining on the power play. Now the break's on here for Ed Courtney. Courtney looks for support. Goes for the shot. The rebound comes away. Priestley's backhand shot is blocked as well. Takes a deflection. Officials wave it on. Power play clock counting down. We'll bring back onto the ice Tim Cranston. Once again on the power play, Sheffield, the short-handed team, outshot Manchester there. No power play goals so far tonight. We've seen just 4 2-minute penalties, and 3 of them have been against Sheffield. Well, we can go ringside for the news from Rick. Oh.
There, you're looking in your screen there, Ken Priestley. Now, just a few weeks ago, they had the Tim Cranston testimonial match, and they had a hardest shot contest. Believe it or not, Ken Priestley won. He's got a howitzer of a shot. He clocked one up with the radar gun, 93 miles an hour. So if you feel sorry for someone out there tonight, feel sorry for Grant Shervin trying to face him.
Well, I reckon we saw one of those 93 mile an hour shots in midweek here from Priestley. But shot goes in this time from Hoffman for Manchester. And Hibbert didn't quite know where the rebound came, but eventually this is cleared away. Bolia with the break, chance here. Getting forward here, great effort for Manchester Storm.
Oh, dear. Once again, a turnover, eh, Tony? You saw it there. Flinton coming on the other side of that, but he saw Rick Brevent driving for the net. Great pass here.
But how about Hibbert?
What a save. He just stacks those pads because Brevent realizes he's got to get that puck upstairs. He gets it up. Hibbert's there, body and all.
Well,
huge save.
I'm sure Rick Brabant would like a birthday goal. Jim Hibbert denying him there. Impressive figures for the young goaltender.
Kind of an interesting comment as well, Tony, getting back to that Tim Cranston testimonial game. They're speaking about hard shots and things, and I was talking to some of the guys, and our man Nick Rothwell played in that game, and guys are saying to me that he couldn't score with a funnel. You know, he was really having a tough time that night.
How powerful was Nick Rothwell's top shot? Into the corner. Battle is joined here. This is Rick Brabant in possession. Rick Brabant, we've got a penalty call here again in a moment. As the rust up breaks out, the penalty call is on the edge of the crease, but more rust up in the corner. Bolio involved again in the thick of it.
Well, Rick Brabant showing his composure there because he knew that a penalty was being called. Frankie Kovacs pestering him the whole time. It's just a one-on-one battle here, but Brevent's awful strong on the puck. You can see it. He could fight back here, but he's not going to do it. He's wanting them to take that penalty so his team can go on the power play. That's that sacrifice that you sometimes have to make.
Well, Frank Kovacs getting his second penalty of the game, and yet another power play will come the way of the Manchester Storm him. 2+2 he's got, which means that, Sheffield, Manchester have an advantage now for up to 4 minutes to try and produce a goal.
2+2, the first being the slashing call, the second being the roughing call.
Referee Mike Rowe himself Cromwell, the next player.
I don't know if Kurt Kleinendorst will be. Obviously, he wants his team to have these power play opportunities, but, you know, their power play a bit flat at the moment. As we know, they've been outshot in the last couple of chances that they've had here, so they've got to try and regroup themselves. Sometimes when you go on a power play, perhaps you let up ever so little. It's time when you've got to concentrate and bear down.
Well, we saw Kurt there on the bench, and his assistant coach, Darrell Lipsy, plays a big part as well. Manchester then on the power play. Jago with a shot, rebound. Morin picks it up. Loose puck the way of Manchester Storm. Jablonski will fire it left. Jago can't keep it in. This is Viklander. He finds Jablonski. Morrison and Morin have to clear the attacking zone. They do now, and they can start again from the neutral zone. This is Jablonski. Morin knocks it around the boards. The chase is on. Goaltender Hibbert knocks it down. Kept in well by Dale Jago. Jago looks for the chance for the shot. Jablonski can't control it. And another penalty call. And we've got a slashing call coming out here. And I think it's...
Well, Dave Morrison not very happy there off the play.
Tim Cranston makes his second visit to the box as well.
Well, this is the top angle here, right at the top end of our screen. There it is, right across the ankle area there and that sort of thing. The problem is Mike Groh is right there to see that. Now, players don't like that one because there's not a lot of protection in and around the ankle area. And you take a blade there, that's awful, awful sore.
And with those two now sitting in the bench, it means we have at least 2 minutes of Manchester Storm skating 5-on-3. That will worry those two, Guy Toole and Alex Dampier, the Sheffield coaching team.
Well, that's Alex Dampier saying to Clyde Toole, hey, fellas, we can't do crap like that. Probably didn't say it that way. But that's just the point, you know, they're already one man down, and obviously a bit of a cheap play. And of course, 5-on-3 is the answer.
That record you saw there shows 3 power plays tonight from which they failed to capitalize. Surely now, with the 5-on-3 situation, Manchester could do. Miller knocks it round to Woodcroft. Woodcroft's got support. The big shots are out here. This is Katola. Dave Morrison. Woodcroft misses an open goal as it comes across the crease. They will try again. This is Miller. Katola dummies the shot. Miller's got some strength with his shot. Goalkeeper saves. Puck comes loose for the chances here. Again, Goldwoods and Hibbert actually ducked out the way of that one as it went sailing over his bar. They've cleared the zone and Manchester will storm forward again. This is Craig Woodcroft. Goes by Big Mike Ware. Dave Morrison. Look for the man behind him, that's Katola. Katola's got the support of Miller. Good defensive work by Sheffield with Woodcroft in possession. Goaltender Hibbert knocks that down with his stick, but Del Monte gets back to help out. Katola playing the puck around again. Woodcroft misses this on the far side of the crease. The penalty clock's gone down. Sheffield managed to change all 3 men that they have among outskaters all at one go. Coming forward now is Chris Miller. This is Hilton Ruggles. He spreads it to Viklander with a big shot. Knocked away by the goaltender. Shot lack power that time. Sheffield fans getting behind their team as they defend well and show battling qualities. And again, clear their defensive zone.
Sometimes when you have a 5-on-3 advantage, you try and be a bit too fancy. And I think you've got to stick to the basics and do what you do so very best. Viklander, sometimes he's looking for making that pass.
Jago! Dave Jago with his second goal of the game. That one on the power play. The shot, tremendous. Almost the back of the net. That's Manchester League.
Well, I was just about to say that they look a little too fancy because they move the puck too much, but this time it works for them. Jago the trailer, no one on him. The triangle on the defense for the Sheffield Steelers is breaking down. They're getting a bit tired out there. Jago picks his spot, and I'm afraid when the puck's moving like it is here, these kind of guys are going to make no mistake.
Well, we've got the situation there now.
When you have a two-man advantage, you have that much more time.
And still, we'll have a one-man advantage for Manchester. And that power play goal providing Dale Jago with his 7th league goal of the season.
Referee's
I don't know, somebody else is in the penalty box for the Sheffield Steelers. I don't know, is that Tony Hands in there? He's picked up a misconduct penalty.
Well, Tony Hand getting a minor penalty, which retains the two-man advantage for Manchester Storm, and also a 10-minute misconduct penalty. That counting, of course, as an individual penalty, but the 2 minutes is against his team, and still we have the two-man advantage.
Now, Tony Hand not very happy. Not very often he loses his temper like that either. He's very, very upset. He feels, I'm certain, that the Steelers shouldn't have been in that situation, having to kill a two-man penalty.
Well, they'd almost killed it off. Dale Jago scored the offence from Tony Hand, the unsportsmanlike conduct, and still it's 5-on-3. Before tonight, Tony Hand had just 4 minutes of penalties in the league. Now that's increased to 16. Again, Keon Jago. This is Nick Lander, big shot, big save. Is Nicky Chin. This is Vic Lander in the neutral zone. Sprayed right. This is Dale Jago getting forward. Just over 4 minutes remaining on the period, and Manchester leading 3-0. Again with two-man advantage. Vic Lander gets forward. Vic Lander will go all the way. Brilliant save by Hibbert. Diving at his feet, soccer style.
Well, that spells danger to me, because Michael Vic Lander is the last man back, but he makes the move. He gets away with it on this occasion. Goes in, but runs out of room, I'm afraid. Jimmy Hibbert, he's down, but he good, great job of concentrating on the puck here and, of course, making a huge save. You've got to try and take the body on these big guys as well. And have you do that, that play wouldn't have happened, would it? Because Ed Courtney would have picked that puck up. He would have taken his man, potentially got the puck out of the zone, or maybe even had a breakaway himself.
Well, Jim Hibbert having a busy time in this period. The face-off to his right, deep in that Sheffield defensive zone, and Manchester Storm have a two-man advantage. Face-off won by Ken Priestley. Priestley thinks he's hooked down there, so do the Sheffield fans. Vic Lander, Katola in possession. Miller goes for the shot. Rebound knocked away by Wilson. Good poke check to clear the danger, and Priestley could have the break here. Priestley goes all the way, but great skating back by the speedy Katola to win the puck, and now on this side send Brent Rubichuk forward. Katola again. Miller to his right. It would be Miller's shot, goalwards, just off target. This is Dave Morrison. Woodcroft tries to play it with his skate. Miller and Katola combine well. A good interception by Del Monte. Well, back onto the ice comes Frank Kovacs at the expiry of his 2+2. Leaving a few seconds remaining of Tony Hand's 2 minute penalty. The expiry of that now will bring Sheffield back up to strength. But could it be in time? As Woodcroft finds the net just as the man comes back on the ice. Goal number 4 for Manchester Storm. And Craig Woodcroft it is that knocks that in for his 12th league goal of the season.
Plenty of patience being shown here by the Manchester Storm around the net. Davey Morrison doing some good hard work. But a lucky bounce there, because that puck wasn't going to get through. And of course, you leave Craig Woodcroft alone in front of the net, and he's going to score every time. There's the miss by the defenseman. Unfortunately, nobody back there watching Craig Woodcroft, who's at the side of the net all alone here. He's dynamite around the net.
Well, within a split second of the 2 minute penalty of Tony Hand expiring, Craig Woodcroft slotting home, and those penalties have cost Sheffield dear, with 2 goals in that time from Dale Jago and Craig Woodcroft. Sheffield 0, Manchester 4. And during that extended power play period, officially counting 4 power plays, 9 shots hit goalwards. is Mike Morrison. Morin knocks it into the corner. Kellen can't control that. Kept in well there by Troy Neumeyer. Put under pressure. This is Shooter spreading it right. But up the ice, Stephen Cooper could lose out here to Scott Addison. Chance to get forward here from Courtney. Great save by Grant Sherman, narrowing the angle well on the powerful shot.
Well, you give Courtney an opportunity. That's why he's one of the top goal scorers in the league this year. You can't give him that opportunity. The turnover down there deep in the zone. There's a phrase that's used. When you get that puck, you should never go back in your zone. You should always try and move it forward in the other direction because you're only looking for trouble for yourself.
Scott Addison gets the puck into the Manchester zone. This is Stephen Cooper. Spread left to Jablonski. The edge of the crease, and Dave Morrison almost getting a touch on that to convert it into a goal. Sheffield will try and clear the zone. This is Longstaff. Great chance here for Hilton Ruggles, but somehow tragic mistake almost made there by Priestley. Longstaff tries to set Sheffield going. Interception from Hoffman. This is Ruggles for Manchester. Ruggles flips it around behind the goal. Chase is on here now. Knocked down by Grant Sherman. 60 seconds remaining on the period. Craig Woodcroft gets it back. Score the fourth goal for Manchester. This is Kevin Hoffman. He'll knock it around the boards. Can Ruggles get it? Beaulieu misses the puck completely. Ruggles with Chase. Priestley getting back well for Sheffield. Smashes it against the boards. Beaulieu helps out with the cover to clear that defensive zone. And this is Cranston. Got support from Priestley. Priestley's got Wilson as the trailer. Wilson goes for the shot. And Sherman produces yet another fine save. Rob Wilson, the frustrated Sheffield captain. Well, on Sherman there. Rob Wilson is having his say. A little bit of rough stuff round. Nicky Chin having words with the linesman. Well, well worth coming over from Manchester. They're having a great night with their team leading 4-0. Face-off is in the Manchester defensive zone now. Can Sheffield pull one back? 26 seconds remaining on this second period. Del Monte loses out on the draw to Woodcroft. This is Troy Neumeyer. Manchester remembering the dark strip defending the goal to our left in this second period. Shudra knocks it goalwards. Knocked down by the glove of Neumeyer. Shudra again gets possession in the neutral zone. He knocks it in early, but his colleagues clear the zone. Big hit by Neumeyer. Denies the opportunity to Del Monte. As Neumeyer holds it up onto the boards. Clock's counting down on the period. There goes the whistle to end the second period. A little bit of argy-bargy round behind the net to end the period. Well, they're all having words to say, but it's been a highly satisfactory period for Manchester Storm. At the end of the period, they lead by 4-0. They started with a one-goal lead from Stefan Katola's first goal, but 2 goals from Dave Jago, the second on the power play, and 1 from Craig Woodcroft, a power play goal, and Manchester a lead of 4-0.
Coming up on Sky Sports on Thursday, it's the Express Cup final. Bracknell in their first ever final, taking on the Air Scottish Eagles, who of course already have 2 pieces of silverware in their trophy cabinet this season. Are they going to get a third? It's Thursday, 8 o'clock on Sky Sports 3. Right now though, in the last weekend of Super League action, the Sheffield Steelers taking on the Manchester Storm here at the House of Steel on Sky Sports 2. A very interesting second period, 3 goals in that period, which makes it 4-0 to the Manchester Storm. A lot of shots on goal, which may be explained partly because of the penalty minutes. The Steelers taking a lot of penalties there. The Manchester Storm capitalising on that. Well, it's been a very interesting game, and I think Bob Carroll might agree that the Manchester Storm look like their lives depend on it, don't they, the way they're playing?
Well, they want that second place, and, you know, that guarantees that they'll stay away from the Air Scottish Eagles, certainly in the first round of the playoffs. And, you know, I think that's important. These coaches, they look and they jockey for positions because they feel that they can do better against certain teams.
Well, it was Dale Jago who took them onto the scoring sheet in the second period, the second goal of the game, Jago's sixth of the season.
Well, the Manchester Storm, they do a great job of moving the puck in the zone. Now, this is a cross-ice pass. I, for one, don't like them because I think you can be intercepted so easily, and if you do, you're in an awful lot of trouble. But this one works. And Jago, of course, he's just one-on-one with a goaltender. He's sort of high in the slot area off to the angle, but he just beats Hibbert on a good hard slap shot.
And then Dale Jago, of course, got the third of the game for Manchester Storm. He's having a great game, isn't he, Jago?
He is, you know. He's sort of one of these silent, if you like, offensive defensemen.
Silent but deadly.
Yeah, he certainly is. There's the penalty, though, that to Rick Brebent, which started to create the penalty trouble for the Sheffield Steelers.
And of course then Craig Woodcroft, who we know as a fantastic goal scorer for the Manchester Storm, had a great season. He's always prevalent, isn't he? Not a surprise to see him on the score sheet.
Not at all. And I mean, all season long he's come up with some very, very big goals for for the Manchester Storm. But the puck is lost deep there. Dave Morrison picks the puck up. He does a lot of hard work here. And of course, I don't think that the Sheffield Steelers defense ever regrouped from this. Bit of a lucky bounce there, but some good concentration by Craig Woodcroft.
Of course, Jago second and that one by Woodcroft, both scored with two-man advantage. The Storm have a great power play record, don't they? And they're making sure there that they're keeping that up.
That's right. I mean, you know, it was mentioned that they actually got outshot there on a couple of power plays, but once they got that 5-on-3, Gabby, I mean, there was no turning back for them. I mean, they put the nail in the coffin.
Any way back for the Sheffield Steelers in this game?
I think it's going to be very difficult for them because I think, you know, you're going to look for some good solid defense from the Manchester Storm. They're very good at getting one man back to make sure that they're not outnumbered in their defensive zone, so let's look for a lot of that.
Thanks very much, Bob. Well, a few other games taking place this evening, of course. Let's have a little look at how they're going. Down there in Basingstoke, the Nottingham Panthers have equalised. It was 1-0 to Basingstoke after the first period. The Panthers have got back. An interesting game down there in Bracknell. The Cardiff Devils were down after the first period, but they've come right back there to make it 4-4 in Bracknell at the moment. Well, if you were with us last Sunday, you'd have seen the Air Scottish Eagles going for their first ever Super League title against the Newcastle Cobras. It was a thrilling evening. We were all on the edge of our seats, but the Newcastle Cobras weren't going to let Air walk away with that trophy without a very hard fight.
And now the break is on here. Whoa, brilliant piece of defensive work there. And Newcastle could be proud of that. This is Mark Wolfe. Chance of a shot for Montanari. Eventually, Varney clears the danger. This is Sam Grelot for the Scottish Eagles. Camus the trailer. Shot's just off target. Wolf squeezed away. Sam Grelot gets an opportunity. Mark Wolf it is with the shot. Nearly takes a deflection and two brilliant saves in split seconds apart there for the goaltender Wayne Cowley. This is Sam Grelot to the cheers of the Centrum. Grelot eased off that. The chance of the back. Of the Air fans, but Trumbly retains possession. The shot goes in now, but Randy Smith and somehow Rob Dobson get that out. Scott Young will surely hold on to the puck for as long as he can. Young clears it into the neutral zone. The cheers echo around here because we've got a chance on the empty net for Purdy! Dennis Purdy has got his second goal of the game on the empty net with 3 seconds to go, and the league title is now well truly decided the way of the Air Scottish Eagles. They broke, Scott Young started it, Purdy finished it, and here we see the finish was absolutely clinical. The net was empty, and Dennis Purdy produced his second goal of the game. Arena, a second trophy of the season for the Air Scottish Eagles.
glad we were there. It was an amazing evening up in Scotland. The Air Scottish Eagles taking their first ever Super League title. Well, of course, the league is all done and dusted now, and it's on to other things for the Air Scottish Eagles. Their third chance to claim some more silverware this season. It's the final of the Express Cup next Thursday. They're going to be taking on the Bracknell Bees in their first ever final. A historic evening all round. Here's a taster of what's to come. I'm a burning effigy of everything I used to be. You're my rock of empathy, my dear. So come on, let me entertain you. Let me entertain you. Last a shot for you to die. So grab yourself an alibi. Heaven knows your mother lied. Well, it's going to be a great evening, and two lucky winners will be joining us up there in Newcastle, because on Thursday, when we were here for the semi-final of the Express Cup, we asked you this question. Who did the Sheffield Steelers beat in last season's playoff final? The answer was, of course, the Nottingham Panthers. And we've got two winners. Helen Bryce of Lancashire and Peter Bradley of Fife will be going an overnight accommodation. We've got VIP tickets. We'll be able to meet the hospitality and the players and £100 worth of travel expenses. And of course, you can join us on that one on Sky Sports. We're going to be 8 o'clock in Newcastle. It's going to be a great evening. Again, the Bracknell Bees against the Air Scottish Eagles on Sky Sports 3, live and exclusive. Right now, though, it's the last weekend of the Super League, and the Manchester Storm fans have got a lot to be happy about, because the late surge by their team stands them in great stead for the playoffs. It's 4-0 here. This is the goal that made it 3-0 by Dale Jago. Join us for the third period after the break. See you then. Back to FA Cup action on Wednesday night as we travel to Oakwell for the fifth round replay between Barnsley and Manchester United. The winner, of course, will face Newcastle in the next round. That's live FA Cup football coming up Wednesday night, 7:30 on Sky Sports 2. Right now, though, Super League action. The Sheffield Steelers against the Manchester Storm, live and exclusive on Sky Sports 2. Well, Nick Rothwell always has the ins and outs of what's going on behind the scenes in ice hockey, and I think he's got something very interesting for us. Nick?
Gabby, you know, it's going into the third period, the players are wet, their equipment's all wet, and this thing actually sorts things out for them with their gloves. Now, with their gloves, with the palms, this bit here, it gets really wet, and that's the bit that they obviously hold the stick with, so they're trying to dry it out. And this is how they do it. Hair dryer over here, normal hair dryer, some plastic plumbing, and it goes off into these bits here, comes up and dries the gloves nice. These are Kenny Priestley's spare pair. He's drying those out, and they can have other pairs. They're just blocking that off there, and that's the hair dryer thing there. Gabby, it's a pretty good hair dryer. My hair is actually a little bit wet, so I'm just going to sort it out for you.
Nick, your hair always looks gorgeous. No wonder he's such a good-looking guy, isn't he, Bob Corral? He's got all those beauty aids down there.
Well, this is it. You know, I think he spends half the game down there working on things, certainly. I like the cans he's wearing now as well. You know, he's changed up.
That's to protect his ears, of course. So looking good in the face and sounding good as well. Thanks very much for that, Nick. Well, let's join our commentary team now. Bob Corral is going to head his way up to join Tony Millard.
Third period about to start. Manchester Storm seemingly in control and leading 4-0, but the Sheffield Steelers are not done yet. The goals coming so far, two from Joe Dago in that period and Craig Woodcroft. Remember Stephen Cotola's goal in the first period. Much of the penalties have hit Sheffield. We've seen seven minor penalties and a misconduct for Tony Hand. And, well, very few penalties the way of the Manchester Storm, just 2 minutes to Dave Morrison, so it's told on the ice. Manchester lead 4-0. In this period, Manchester Storm, the visitors in the darker strip, defend the goal to our right, and Sheffield Steelers in the lighter strip, their home strip, they are playing from left to right in front of us. Scott Allison, it is in possession now in the neutral zone. This is Big Mike Ware. Flipped in off the stick of Kevin Hoffman onto the boards where Miller knocks it around. Cleared out of that defensive zone. It's time by Mike Morin. The icing call will take the action inside the first half minute. Here's Ken Priestley. See the marks of the cut that he suffered in his head in the game here on Thursday, which required stitches. Wearing the face mask. Big crowd here tonight at Sheffield. They enjoy their ice hockey. 7,815 in here, a near capacity attendance in this Sheffield arena. And they're enjoying it. Also enjoying it, the man next to me, Bob Carroll. Chase around the rink from the studio. Shot goes in, nearly a deflection. Sherman has to be equal to that. Good work here by Kevin Hoffman, but he's denied possession by Courtney. Good support here. Priestley on the turn, can't get the shot away. Sherman with the poke check. Great chance here for Courtney, who fires it over the bar from point blank range. He really had the goal at his mercy.
Well, he's got some confidence in there too. Sherman's down, he's struggling to gain position in the net. Courtney knows he's got to go upstairs, but unfortunately just goes a bit too high.
Dave Morris in possession, trying to avoid the check by Shudra. Jim Hibbert, the goaltender for Sheffield, knocks it down behind his net. Now Ken Priestley will come forward. Priestley combining with Courtney, interception from Rubichuk. Rubichuk looks for support in the end, has to go on his own for Manchester. Craig Woodcroft is number nine, will knock it around the boards. Petola chases it, helped around the boards by the goaltender. This is two goal Dale Jago. Jago goes for his hat trick. Neumeier flicks it into the zone and oh, a little bit of slashing there, and Craig Woodcroft getting involved in a battle there with Mike Ware. Play allowed to go on. This is Kovacs in possession for Sheffield. Desperate to break this ducky. Eventually good poke check clears it from Craig Woodcroft. Calls for replacements from the bench. Manchester in fact managed to change their entire lineup of outskaters. This is Corey Bolio holding it up against the balls in the neutral zone. Manchester looking comfortable at the moment, Bob.
Yeah, Corey Bolio, very solid on defense there tonight, you know, and I like this guy because when he gets the puck, he gets so much room because guys don't like sort of going near him, huh? And I think it's got a lot to say with those 176 minutes in penalties that he carries forward. Very rough, tough customer out there.
Didn't get quite so many penalties in his cup games, though. I think he got about 8 minutes in the cup games. Face off in the neutral zone. Draw one by Manchester Storm. This is Mikhail Viklander, Stephen Cooper. This is Bolio. Interception by Rick Brabant. Chance here for Hilton Ruggles. Ruggles with the shot. Brilliant save by Hibbert. Shot goes goalwards from Cooper. Takes a deflection. This is Chris Kellen for Sheffield. Didn't get much ice time early on, but Kovacs on the break. Fans yell for a penalty over here because I think that... I thought that Tim Cranston thought he was brought down, but they're still playing. Sheffield in possession. Mike Ware will get forward. Ware with the shots off target. Shudra with the shot. Kicked away by Grant Sherman, who's having an inspired game tonight. Things have been good for Manchester going towards those playoffs, Bob.
Well, certainly is. Like I said, Grant Sherman has been hot of late. He's been playing very, very well in some crucial games to get Manchester into the situation they're in. They wanted to get that second place. They want to try and avoid the Air Scottish Eagles for as long as they possibly can, I'm certain.
Kevin Hoffman on the break for Manchester, number 25. Mike Morin feeds inside to Dave Morrison. Morrison sees the puck off the end of his stick, and this is Del Monte for Sheffield. Picked away by Sherman. Well, I think Grant Sherman coming in tonight here, and his recent record in the last three games, he must be delighted with his form, the 27-year-old goaltender. But Sheffield won't give up. This is Longstaff knocking the puck in. Puck held up against the ball. Scott Allison fires it into the far corner. Kevin Hoffman comes away for Manchester. Craig Woodcroft to his right, just in front of him. Going on the overlap is Stefan Katola. This is Katola. Dummies the shot. Good angle from the goaltender. Hibbert keeps it out. Courtney gets the break for Sheffield. Jago across. Powerful interception there. produces the icing call because it's his own half the ring, and that will produce a face-off in the Manchester zone.
Perhaps a little bit of pressure off of the Manchester Storm. Dale Jago there, you can see a bit of a happy look on him there. Two goals he scored, showing his offensive capabilities. And once again, keeping that ball rolling for the Manchester Storm on the power play.
What about these Manchester Storm defensive hook? We've got Jago, we've got Miller, we've got Vic Lander. The shooting power on the blue line is tremendous for them.
Well, they are. They're all very offensive, which is a bit of a contrast, I think, to perhaps most of the teams that you see in the league. And, you know, I think if Kurt Kleinendorf maybe looked at his defense, he maybe felt that he needs a player like perhaps a Corey Beaulieu, a guy that's good and big and physical out there, just to make sure that everybody's honest in and around that net.
Well, they've got 24 league goals between them, and now here comes a chance for Brad Rubichuk on the break. Good save by the goaltender and the rebound. Rubichuk had a great chance to make it five, but now it's Sheffield on the break this time here, and across comes Jago in again with the interception. This is Priest. He won't be happy to be four goals down. Oh, the goalkeeper doesn't know where that is, and eventually, somehow, well, Grant Sherman, he must have had a black cap who got in front of him on his way here tonight.
Well, he's got it underneath him, but I'm just wondering whether this shot, in fact, hits the post or where it hits. I don't know. It maybe hit the side of the net, but it's not across the goal line just as easily it could have by Grant Sherman putting it in. But Ed Courtney, ever so sharp around that net there, and he's always willing to let that shot go. He's got that good, quick release. He's like a Jamie Leach. Anytime you give him an opportunity to shoot the puck, he's going to do it. That hits the post, Tony.
Well, Grant Sherman didn't know where it was, and Ed Courtney hoped it was in the net. It wasn't.
Well, he hasn't played as many games as everybody, Ed Courtney, in the league, because he came as it started. But you can see he can score goals, averaging a goal a game.
Powerful shot too. This is Rick Brabant. Clearing that defensive zone. Mike Ware fires it left. Ron Schubel tries to get his team going. And that produces... Oh! A big hit mid-ice there. Brabant involved. And, well, big Mike Ware, I think it was, came at him there.
Well, this started between Rick Brabant and Kenny Priestley coming out of the zone. A little bit of argy-bargy, as you say it, but it wasn't long before big Scott Ellison got involved. If you like the second man in, Kenny Priestley heads to the penalty box. Well, there's the two of them. That's Scott Ellison coming along, and he's the second man in on this particular play. And I think that he's got a game misconduct penalty as a result of that. Kenny Priestley gets the roughing call, and I'm sure that will be the call on Rick Brabant as well. There's Scott Ellison. He's a bit unhappy with that call, he felt. He took a crack at Rick Brabant, but unfortunately, I don't know if he got the best of him.
Well, certainly Sheffield will be far from happy. And that man, Alex Dampier, is still waiting to hear what it's all about. Well, all hell letting loose down in front of us here.
Well, the team's wanting to perhaps clear the benches here. I don't know, a lot of Sheffield Steelers players on the ice.
Well, the penalty that's caused the problems here is the third man in call on Scott Ellison, who gets a game misconduct, and he's far from happy, as you see, down the corridor there.
Well, he gives it the old long bomb with a helmet, but he's away to the showers early.
Well, down in front of us, all hell breaking loose in front of the benches.
This is partially a frustration sort of thing, I think, on behalf of the Sheffield Steelers as well. They're feeling the heat a little bit. It hasn't been their sort of game.
Well, Nick Rothwell is down ringside. He can tell us all about what's going on down there.
Guys, right now it's just a question of Sheffield's frustration. It's just boiling over a little bit, and you could see the guys there offering out the Manchester Storm. Manchester doing the right thing, backing away, saying, no, you know, we got a four-goal lead, 14 minutes left. But Sheffield, they're just going to start settling. Alex is trying to get the guys to settle down on the bench right now, and I'm sure they're going to settle down for the last 14 and try and play some good hockey.
Well, an interesting statistic by Manchester backing off there, which Nick spotted and told us about, is that Manchester are the least penalised team in the league. But the net result of all that is the coincidental minors, which means both teams escape 4-on-4, plenty of space on the ice, and Scott Addison is out for the game.
Well, you've got to show your composure in those sorts of circumstances, which is what Rick Brevent did, because he could have easily got involved there and got thrown out of the game, but the Manchester Storm already have a bit of a short bench, and they can't afford to really lose any players.
This is Cooper in possession as Manchester clear. Another penalty call here. We've got a delayed penalty call here. This time will be on Manchester as soon as Sheffield lose possession, and Sheffield will get the power play and will skate 4-on-3. Still Sheffield in possession, still this delayed penalty call. Referee Mike Rowe holds his hand up, possession is lost, and now another one breaks out in front of the crease there with Mikael Wiklander. But we've got a high sticks penalty, I think, on Stephen Cooper of Manchester, and he will go to the box.
Well, Stephen Cooper, as you say, goes off on a high sticking call. Again, a bit of an innocent play, but Mike Rowe, he's trying to keep control of this game.
Well, there's Stephen Cooper, number 55, to the right there with the penalty. That's Stephen Cooper will sit out 2 minutes, and now we have a power play the way of Sheffield Steelers. And
the puck just getting away from Stephen Cooper there. Tim Cranston on a bit of a strong forecheck, and he gets the dump, and of course Stephen Cooper sits the 2 minutes for the high stick.
Well, they're sorting out how they work it out, but as I see it, it's Sheffield with 4 out skaters, Sheffield Manchester with 3, plenty of space on the ice. Sheffield power play.
Well, they've got a good power play, the Sheffield Steelers, if they can get it rolling. We've seen that before.
This is Rob Wilson. Manchester Storm defending well. There's Kevin Hoffman waxing up the ice. Jim Hibbert will knock it down. Courtney and Shufra. Sheffield with 4 out skaters. Manchester with 3 out skaters. And Stephen Cooper going in the bench onto the bench. Previously, of course, we had 2 coincidental minors. This is Shufra. Shot will go in from Wilson. Still to create space. Narrow angle shot, and that goes all the way around the boards and up to the far end of the rink where Hibbert will knock it down. And Sheffield will try and build for the back a second time with Rob Wilson. Courtney fractionally offside, spotted by the linesman there. Ed Courtney disappointed at that.
Well, so often now we see in the league a man playing high, which in this case is Ed Courtney, and that's to push those defensemen of the opposition back to give the guy coming forward to the puck a little bit more room. Of course, offside the call here. And the puck goes back to where the pass was originated, and that's where the faceoff will take place.
Well, that's an interesting statistic there for Manchester Storm, because their penalty killing record is tremendous at the moment. And there are their fans. Sheffield, though, in possession. Puck cleared up the ice by Hoffman. This is Wilson behind the goal. Into the corner it goes. The chase is on for Manchester. Good cover for Manchester there from Chris Miller to knock it around the boards as Sheffield piled in. Jim Hibbert helping his men out of the back. This is Wilson, the Sheffield captain. Ron Shudra, his alternate captain, in front of him. Good skating here from Tim Cranston. Now skating 5-on-4. Brabant with a shot as he comes back on the ice. Brabant! Oh, so nearly celebrating his birthday with a goal as he came back onto the ice. The two came on from that coincidental minor. Still the power play. The clock counting down now. And, well, there's 7 seconds, I think, remaining on the power play. And the Manchester have defended well.
Here's why you want to know that it's important to make sure you got that man covered as he comes out of the penalty box, because that's Rick Brabant and certainly Ken Priestley as well. There's the one-on-one. Brabant manages to get his rebound. Hibbert again, a very good save.
Face-off then is deep in the Manchester defensive zone. 5 seconds is that power play. Clock counting down. Waiting to come back on the ice over the far side. Penalty doors are open. Manchester are back up to strength. They've survived yet another power play. Good penalty killing. And now they push forward. Manchester scored one power play goal tonight. Oh, goal for Manchester. Goal going in there off the stick of Jablonski. The Manchester Storm take control and lead 5-0.
Tell you, once the Manchester Storm get that puck in the offensive zone, I tell you, they do a great job of moving it. Over to Dave Morrison. Now look at the heads-up play that he makes here. He waits for that trailer, that guy, wide guy going for the net, who's Jeff Jablonski. Plenty of time, though, because he takes a couple of guys with him. Jablonski all alone. No Sheffield Steelers around him there, as he's got a one-timer past Jimmy Hibbert.
Sheffield now up against it. They want to break the shutout, but Manchester leading 5-0. And Ron Sherman, that goalkeeper there in the middle of your picture, will be pleased with the circumstances coming into the side here and at the moment holding Sheffield scoreless. But Sheffield won't give up. They're trying here. Again, Sherman with the score. Oh dear, two saves there at that point-blank range. Reaction save from Priestley on that second shot was quite extraordinary.
Well, Tony Hand's one of these guys that when he gets the puck deep in the zone, he can do all kinds of things with it. But the Manchester Storm actually struggled to clear the puck out of harm's way there. Sherman having to come up with a huge save with that glove. Kenny Priestley, I think if he wanted to do it all over again, what would he do? This goaltender goes down. Look at this. There he is. He's down. He's flat on the ice. What's open? The top part of the net. But it's the puck's just moving a little bit too much for him. He just can't get a stick on it.
Well, Manchester's biggest win of the season. They've had a couple of 6-0 victories and an 8-3 win. But here tonight, they're leading 5-0. This is Mike Morin, Bob was talking about. Oh, Morin couldn't get through there as the two defensemen closed the door and he tumbled down. But still, it's Manchester on the attack. Looking for the wraparound. Morin has the chance. Good clearance here. It's Courtney. Sending away Chris Kellen getting forward. Tony Hand on the far side. And maintaining his quality. This is Courtney. Courtney goes for the shot just off target. That was vicious. Stephen Cooper. Puck held up against the boards and that will produce the face-off down in that Manchester zone.
Well, it's that much sweeter, isn't it, when you come across the Pennines, as you say, into a game where your team's up 5-0, especially in one of the most difficult buildings to play in the Super League.
Well, they know that playoff final will be in their own building, and they want to see their team there.
That's for certain, and you know, I guess if you can dance, Tony, and if you can dance anywhere, because the Manchester Storm fans are certainly pleased with their team's result here this evening.
I've just got the feeling, Bob, if they make that playoff final, it'll be the biggest crowd ever to watch a hockey match in Britain, because that stadium will be packed to capacity if the Storm get there.
Well, it certainly will, and you know, they're going to be a difficult team to beat at home as well, but that's not taking anything away from the Air Scottish Eagles, because they've been so consistent all season long that they're going to be difficult to beat.
Long stop with the shot. Another save from Grant Sherman. He'll remember this night. This is Rick Brabant, the birthday boy, who also remember the night. Dale Jago in possession with two goals to his name. Time is on the side of the Manchester Storm. They're playing games now behind the net there as Jago dummies with it. This is Brabant. Jago's with him, sprays it left to Neumeier. Neumeier's pass wide right. It's a chance to Eric Flinton to break. Brabant is the trailer. Referee Rowe gets in the way as Brabant backhands it around the boards. This is Dion Del Monte and Nicky Chin for Sheffield. This is Nicky Chin getting forward. Brabant gets it back to Neumeier. Neumeier's got Jago to his right. They're protecting their goaltender at the moment with just under 7 minutes remaining, and Sherman looking for a shutout. Last time these two teams met in the league, Sheffield was shut out 4-0 by Manchester. The goalie that night was Jim Rivnak. But it's not all over yet as Sheffield come forward. Manchester clear that right up the ice. That will produce the icing call, a break for both teams, and a face-off in the Manchester zone. Well, we can look forward to Thursday, where you can join us here on Sky Sports. It's Bracknell against Ayr in the Express Cup final at the Newcastle Arena, and it starts at 8 o'clock on Sky Sports 3. The Sheffield fans are still partying here in their own arena. They'll celebrate a goal, they hope. I wonder if he knows what the score is.
I don't think he really matters, but that's what I call stomping Tom Connors, eh?
I think he's a Manchester fan. Ruba chucked around to clear the danger. Sherman now put under some pressure. Cranston loses his stick. Manchester come forward. This is Woodcroft. Woodcroft still in possession. Taken into the boards by Mike Ware. Comes back for Cotola, and the court puck goes into the net in the end. I think the final touch goes in there for Brad Rubichuk.
Well, Craig Woodcroft does all the dirty work on this play. He's often the goal scorer, but he digs it out because he's got a lot of pressure on him. There you see Mike Ware around him. But again, paths get crossed here, and no one picks up the trailer so very well. Frankie Kovacs, which enables the shot to get away here by Brad Rubichuk. And he's the trailer on the play. He's the guy in the slot area, and that's where the puck has to go to.
Brad Rubichuk.
He scores, and he doesn't make any mistake.
So Brad Rubichuk's 10th league goal of the season. He's also scored 10 in the cup. His 20th in total in the Manchester jersey this season. Sheffield 0, Manchester 6. This is Frank Kovacs on the break for Sheffield. Dump forward, comes back down off the plexiglass. This is Kevin Hoffman. Remember, until tonight, Manchester hadn't won a league game in this arena. They've beaten Sheffield in the Benson Hedges Cup. The other five matches they played here have all been won by Sheffield. Well, Manchester did have another 6-0 away win this season. I saw that down at Bracknell earlier in the season. They beat Newcastle at home 6-0. This one tonight could be their third 6-0 victory if it stays like this. Could they increase that? This is Mike Morin. Morrison inside him, Jablonski on this side. Mike Morin goes all the way, kicked away by Jim Hibbert. This is Tony Hand in possession for Sheffield. Still cheered on by their fans as Hand dumps it into the corner. Sherman watches it carefully round the boards. Morin taken into the boards. Morin for Manchester is in control. Cooper on this side wants the puck. Eventually may get it. Morin knocks it forward. That could produce an icing call inside his own half of the rink. Officials wave it on though now. This is Priestley trying to set Sheffield going. Flipped inside to Wilson, who's coming forward. He knocks it into the corner where Courtney will chase him. He's beaten to it by Neumeier for Manchester. This is Shudra. Knocks it around the boards. Courtney turns it this side. Priestley creates a chance. Backhand shot by Tony Hand just off target. Hand and Brabant battle. A few points between them in their careers. This is Eric Flinton for Manchester. Hilton Ruggles on this side. Puck held up against the boards. We're into the final 4 minutes of the game. Rick Brabant just rattles the pipework along the right-hand side of the goaltender. This is Flinton. Knocks it forward. The chase is on for Ruggles. Ron Schudra gets there first for Sheffield. This is Miller for Manchester, number 77. Chris Miller, 18 league and cup goals this season, the top goal-scoring defenceman in all competitions. This is him. Brad Rubichuk scored goal number 6. He feeds Katola, scorer of goal number 1. This is the fast-skating Swede, Katola, to Rubichuk. And this side is Kevin Hoffman. Nicky Chin tries to knock him out of the zone. Knocked around the boards by Rob Wilson for Sheffield. This is Dion Del Monte. Knocked forward and Sheffield will chase. It's dump and chase at the moment. But very much Manchester's night, Bob, as the penalty's called there.
We got another call here. Tripping call on Brad Rubichuk as he goes to the bench. A little over 2 minutes left in this game. Perhaps something for the Sheffield Steelers to try and salvage on this power play.
Well, power play to Sheffield Steelers. 2 minutes and 44 seconds remaining. Power play with the Sheffield Steelers, and they need a goal to break that shutout. Wry smile on Brad Rubichuk's face. Well, 42 shots have rained in so far on Grant Sherwin. Between the pipes for Manchester and that man there, Alex Dampier, worried, I think, about his team 6-0 down.
Well, the shot's fairly even there as we see it, Tony, but, you know, specialty teams penalties is part of the reason why it's a 6-0 game, and, you know, you can't allow the Manchester Storm to have a man advantage and feel that you're going to get away from that free.
Trying here, all they're worth, this is Rob Wilson, goaltender, sees that go by off the backhand of Wilson's stick, that went just wide. The Manchester fans, the Sheffield fans are still cheering on the power play to try and get Sheffield to break the deadlock. This is Tony Hand. Sherwin knocks it away, the goaltender. Shots have piled in on him tonight. Well, my perfect time between the pipes for Grant Sherwin. This is Tony Hand. And trying to create space. Chance here for Wilson on this side as it goes into the corner. Final 2 minutes of the game. Cranston. Shot goes in again. And somehow knocked away. Just wide of the goal. This is Tony Hand. This is Cranston. Tony Hand in possession. Whacked around the boards. Rob Wilson will try and keep it in for Sheffield. This is Cranston combining on this side with Kovacs. Kovacs is number 12. Tony Hand in possession. Manchester defending as if their life depends upon it here. Can't get the shot for the blue line.
Well, their goaltender's done such a great job on them, and they want to try and persevere the goose egg for them. They don't want the Sheffield Steelers to score.
Well, still he produces a score there! Cranston puts it in! Sheffield have broken that shutout, and Tim Cranston scores at point-blank range just with the power play clock counting down. 8 seconds remaining on the power play. Power play goal Sheffield, Tim Cranston.
Well, the Sheffield Steelers got big, strong forwards, and they drive to the net very, very well. And Tim Cranston had a goal similar to that the other night, but you know it was going to happen because they got all kinds of pressure in front of Grant Sherwin and the Manchester Storm net. He had a chance here to perhaps maybe put his glove on it, but it didn't work for him. And that guy's done a tremendous job tonight, so you certainly can't fault him.
Well, so near and yet so far for Grant Sherwin with that shutout. Tremendous performance by the 27-year-old goaltender who will be playing, it seems now, for the rest of the season, barring injury, with Jim Rybnak having gone back to Canada. This is Eric Flinton. It's a question of clock counting down now, with Manchester in control and leading by 6-1. A great night for Manchester Storm, a disappointing one for the Sheffield Steelers. That consolation goal from Tim Cranston, though, preventing the shutout. This is Nicky Chin for Sheffield. This is Stephen Cooper in possession for Manchester. Final 10 seconds of the game. The assist for Tony Hand on that Cranston goal was his 1400th assist in British hockey. The hooter goes, the match has ended, and Sheffield win by 6-1. Stefan Katola put them in front in the first period. 2 goals from Dale Jago and 1 from Craig Woodcroft made it 4-0 in the second. Goals from Jablonski and Rubachuk made it 6-0. Tim Cranston, the consolation on the power play for Sheffield, made it 6-1 Manchester.
So disappointing for the Steelers, their last game on home ice this season. 6-1 losers to the Manchester Storm, who are hitting form just in time for the playoffs. Who against them making the final at the end of March? Before that, though, it's the Express Cup final. It's live and exclusive on Sky Sports 3 on Thursday. We'll be there for that one at 8 o'clock. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.